le présent continu. So le présent continu, it's an interesting structure because it's the kind of structure that you can use if you want to insist on the fact that an action or something, a process is continuing at the time when you are speaking or talking. Okay, and the way to construct this is to use first this expression, être en train de. So you can see that here we've got the verb être, to be. Okay, and this structure should be obviously at the present time. Okay, and the not the present time, sorry, but the present tense. All right, so you should conjugate your verb être here at the present. Okay, then you will put the verb that you want to use in your structure. This verb should be at the infinitive form, so the basic form of the verb. Okay, so and it will give you this présent continu. Okay, so let's see a few examples. First, je suis en train de faire mes devoirs. Okay, faire is to do, and then mes devoirs, my homework. All right, and then when you use this, je suis en train de. Okay, so you want to insist on the fact that at the time when you are talking, the process is taking place. Okay, and it continues, and that's the whole concept of it. So, je suis en train de faire mes devoirs. All right, second example that we've got, so same thing here. Tu es en train de regarder un film. Okay, so same thing, regarder or to watch un film, a movie. So the action is taking place, and of course it continues if you use this en train de. Okay, but then remember that you've got to put here the verb être at the present form for tu, tu es. Okay, so you need to conjugate it. And then, elle est en train de réparer, so to repair, son vélo, her bike. Elle est en train de réparer son vélo. All right, so same thing, it's continuing, it's taking place at the time when you are talking. And the last one, il est en train de préparer le petit déjeuner. Préparer, to prepare, le petit déjeuner, breakfast. Okay, so il est en train de préparer le petit déjeuner. Okay, so at the time when we are talking, he's doing it right now, and the process is continuing. Okay, so let's read them one more time. Je suis en train de faire mes devoirs. Tu es en train de regarder un film. Elle est en train de réparer son vélo. Il est en train de préparer le petit déjeuner. Okay, so that's what we call le présent continu. But then, if you think about that, well, it would be possible to transpose that at the past as well. Why not? So, let's call it le passé continu. And it's possible because, well, the idea is that you just use the same structure, être en train de, okay? But think about that because we've been covering the past tenses already, and it would be a bit strange to use this passé composé tense, because normally we tend to use this passé composé when we want to express actions, okay? But then, in that case, imparfait would be more appropriate, okay? So if you want to use this passé continu concept, then use être en train de, and you use this imparfait, okay? Then, same idea, you put your verb at the infinitive form, and you will get this passé continu. Okay, so you know what? We'll take exactly the same sentences that we had as examples for the present, but we just put them at the passé. And here we go. J'étais en train de faire mes devoirs. So as you can see, the only thing that will change in this structure is être, okay, because in that case you should put it at the imparfait form. J'étais en train de faire mes devoirs. Tu étais en train de regarder un film. Elle était en train de réparer son vélo. Il était en train de préparer le petit déjeuner. All right, so the only thing that will change here, here and here, it's the verb être that you should put at the imparfait form. All right, and in the same logic, we could put this structure at the future as well. Why not? So, le futur continu. And in that case, Exactly the same structure, so être en train de, but then obviously, so être should be at the future form, okay, so the real one, and then the infinitive form, just to get this future continue. Okay, same example, same sentences, so je serai en train de faire mes devoirs. Tu seras en train de regarder un film. Elle sera en train de réparer son vélo. Il sera en train de préparer le petit déjeuner. Okay, so as you can see, the only thing that will change here is the verb être. So it should be at the future, future simple form. So the real future. Okay, here, here, and here. Okay, le passé récent. Like the recent past, if you want to translate it directly. So, le passé récent is like a false or a fake tense that we've got, because technically it's the present tense, but then if you want to express something that you just did, okay? So, we've got a tense for that, and it's quite useful and quite easy to make, because the concept is that first you will use the verb venir, and the preposition de, okay, so venir is to come, venir de, so this should be at the present tense, and then you will put your verb at the infinitive form, okay, and you will get what we call le passé récent. Okay, so it's a technique just to express something yet that you just did. Okay, so it's not possible to use this passé récent, of course, for last week or the month before. It's not possible. Okay, so it's really something that is somehow connected to the present. So present, something that you just did. Okay, so of course, if you want to make it, you should know the conjugation of venir by heart. If that's not the case, then don't worry. Here it comes. So at the present tense, it's je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient, nous venons, vous venez, ils viennent, elles viennent. All right, so let's see that one more time. Je viens. Final S not pronounced, okay? And when you combine this IEN, you get this yin, yin. Je viens, alright? Tu viens, well, exactly the same thing. Final S not pronounced, and then you get this yin sound, alright? Then il vient, exactly the same sound because final T here is not pronounced. Elle vient, alright? Nous venons. Okay, so final S not pronounced, and then remember that you pronounce this E like a the, venons, okay, O-N in your nose, on, venons, nous venons, all right, vous venez, okay, so a Z at the end combined will give you the sound E, and here you've got E, venez, vous venez, all right, and then il Vienne. So remember, as usual in French, when we talk about conjugation, ENT at the end, you don't pronounce it here. And then you've got this E here, followed by this double N. So double consonant here, so when they are identical, they will open the sound of this E. So you will get it, and it will be produced like E, okay? So Vienne, Vienne. Okay, don't insist on this. Ne, no, viennent, viennent. Okay, ils viennent, elles viennent. All right. So remember, je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient. Nous venons, vous venez, ils viennent, elles viennent. So this is the first part that you should use to make this passé récent. Okay, and remember, after that, you put this preposition de plus your verb at the infinitive. So let's see a few examples now. And the first one, je viens de discuter avec ma sœur. Okay, discuter, to discuss, avec, with my sister, ma sœur. Je viens de discuter avec ma sœur. Okay, something that just happened. All right, And then same thing here. Tu viens de boire un verre de lait. Boire to drink, un verre glace de lait of milk. D'accord? Tu viens de boire un verre de lait. Same thing here. It just happened. Elle vient de gagner le match. Gagner is to win. Le match, obviously, the match. Elle vient de gagner le match. And the last one. Nous venons de déjeuner. OK? Déjeuner here. When you have your lunch, OK? Nous venons de déjeuner. All right? So, je viens de discuter avec ma sœur. Tu viens de boire un verre de lait. Elle vient de gagner le match. Nous venons de déjeuner. All right? So, keep in mind, venir at the present form, as we see here. And then the preposition, la préposition de, and your verb at the infinitive form. And then you get this passé récent, something that you just did. Okay? Le futur proche. So if you want to translate this futur proche directly, it would be like the near future. So technically, it is one way that we've got to express the future, but then we keep a structure that is conjugated at the present tense. Okay? And so to make it, we'll see it right now. First, we need to use the verb aller. Aller is to go. Okay? And well, this verb aller should be at the present tense. Then you will put your verb. Your verb should be at the infinitive, so the basic form of the verb. Then you will get this futur proche structure. Okay, so it is like in English, for instance, when you say I am going to something, that exactly it is exactly the same structure. Okay, express something that you want to do or you are going to do. Okay, but still, it will be at the present tense. Okay, so the only thing that really you should remember and know by heart is the verb aller at the present tense. If you don't remember it, well, don't worry, it is coming right now. Je vais, tu vas, il va, elle va, nous allons, vous allez, ils vont, elles vont. Okay, so this is the verb aller at the present tense. Okay, let's see it one more time. Je vais. Final S not pronounced here, and remember when you combine this A and E together, you get the sound A, so really open. Je vais. Tu vas. Final S not pronounced. Tu vas. Il va. Elle va. Nous allons. Remember, final S not pronounced. O and together, it's on. And then we'll make this little link between the two. What we call the liaison, nous allons. Okay? Then, vous allez. Remember, EZ at the end here will give you this E sound. Okay? Allez. And then, as previously, this little link between the two, liaison, vous allez. Right? Then, ils vont. Final T not pronounced. And then, O and together, on vont. Okay? Ils vont, elles vont. All right, so one more time. Je vais, tu vas, il va, elle va, nous allons, vous allez, ils vont, elles vont. Okay, so that's the only thing that really you should modify or conjugate because after that you will put your verb at the infinitive form. So let's see a few examples now. And the first one, je vais sortir ce soir. Sortir is to go out. Ce soir, this evening. Okay, so I am going to go out. Sounds strange in English. This evening. Okay, in French, well, it's well quite possible here. Je vais sortir ce soir. Then, elle va apporter un gâteau. Apporter is to bring un gâteau, a cake. Elle va apporter un gâteau. Okay, and after that. Nous allons faire du café. Faire is to do, or in that case, it could be to prepare. Du café, some coffee. Nous allons faire du café. Okay. Vous allez partir en vacances. Partir is to go en vacances, on vacation. And here you can see that at the end, we've got this point d'interrogation. So it means that it's a question. And if it's a question, we should raise the voice a little bit at the end. So let's repeat it. Vous allez partir en vacances? Okay, so I tend to insist a little bit, but still, that's the idea. You should raise your voice a little bit at the end just to inform the person that it's a question, okay? Vous allez partir en vacances? Vous allez partir en vacances? Okay, so you can hear it. First, je vais sortir ce soir. Then, elle va apporter un gâteau. Nous allons faire du café. Vous allez partir en vacances? Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And this is Unité 9, Leçon D. And in this lesson, we'll discover together what we call in French le futur antérieur. So le futur antérieur is a tense. Okay, so I thought it might be useful to introduce it right now because we've been covering quite many tenses so far, and this one is quite useful. So the way we will construct this video is first we'll see l'utilisation. So when do we use this futur antérieur? And then the second part will be la formation. So how do we construct? How do we build this this tense? Okay. So the first part will be l'utilisation. When do we use it? And so the main the only concept of this futur antérieur is that it will be used to express what we call le passé dans le futur. So the past in the future. So I know it might sound a bit strange, but still it does exist in other languages, for instance English. So you will see that if you compare it to English, it's almost the same thing and the same construction. Okay, so let's first see. So if we are here, okay, this is the timeline. So if we are here, normally if we want to express what is happening right now, we will use the present tense, so le présent here, okay? And then if we want to talk about the future, then we'll use this futur simple, for instance, so the tense we've been seeing previously, okay? And if we want to talk about what happened before, so it's still, if you look carefully, it's still the future for us, because we are here, it's the present right now, so it's still the future, but you want to really go that way. First the future, then the past. So in a way, it's the past in the future. Alright? So if it's not clear so far, let's see one example. At the future form, so if we want to use this faire is to do, je ferai mes devoirs. Mes devoirs, my homework. Okay? So this is the sentence at the future form. Je ferai mes devoirs. Okay? And if we've got the same sentence, but at the futur antérieur, so it will be like j'aurai fait mes devoirs. Okay? So if you want to translate it directly, see, I will do my homework. And then here, I will have done my homework. So if you feel the difference in English between the two sentences, well, it's exactly the same thing in French. Okay? So strangely, if you say je ferai mes devoirs here, it's the future. Okay? But then if you use the same structure at this futur antérieur, I will have done my homework, then you've got the feeling that of course it's the future, but in a way it's done already. Okay? So it's more certain with this sentence. And it's exactly the same use that we will have in French as it is used in English. Okay? So now, second part, formation. So let's have a look now. First sentence, so it's the real future. Je mangerai au restaurant. Okay? And then here we've got j'aurai mangé au restaurant. So this second part is the futur antérieur. So if we take the time to look a little bit here, we can see that we've got first avoir, okay, at the future. And here we've got this participe passé form that we saw previously, okay. Second example, if we take the sentence, tu regarderas, regarder is to watch, la télévision, okay. Tu auras regardé la télévision. So this is the same structure at the futur antérieur. What can we see? We can see avoir one more time, and it's at the future tense. And then here we can see that we've got the participe passé form. Okay. So third example. Il ira. Ira. So it's coming from aller. Okay. Aller is to go. Au travail, at work. And then here, il sera aller au travail. So we can see that here we've got être, and then we get the participe passé form here. Okay, so what can we deduct? Here we've got avoir, participe passé, avoir, participe passé, être, participe passé. So the rule is like that in most of the cases. If you want to construct this futur antérieur form, first you will have for most of the verbs avoir, and it should be at the futur form, and then the participe passé form, and you will get your futur antérieur. In some cases, you will have to use être at the future form, so le futur, then your participe passé form, and you will get the futur antérieur form. All right, so if you saw the previous videos that we've been doing for other composed tenses in French, like passé composé, plus que parfait, etc., well, it is exactly the same way to construct it. It's the only difference is here, okay? So if you use avoir for one verb at the passé composé form, for instance, you will use avoir as well at the futur antérieur. The only thing that will change is that for this futur antérieur form, it will be here, the futur, okay? And if you use être for some verbs or one verb at the passé composé, it will be exactly the same thing, but keep in mind that here it should be at the futur form, okay? So remember that for être, we've got aller, aller is to go, arriver, arriver to arrive, descendre, to go down, devenir, to become, entrer, to enter, to come in, monter, to go up, mourir, to die, naître, born, partir, to leave, rester, to stay, retourner, to return, sortir, to go out, tomber, to fall, and then venir, to come. Okay, so keep in mind that all these verbs will require être, okay? And then when we talk about être, of course, as usual in French, for these composed tenses, all the reflexive verbs like se something, okay? So se regarder, for instance, or then s'appeler, or then se présenter, so they will all the time require être, okay? And we will see in that video that, of course, the way to conjugate them will be a little bit different, okay? But then, of course, let's see one more time, avoir and être at the future form, because that's the first part you will have to use if you want to construct this futur antérieur. And avoir at the future form goes like j'aurai, tu auras, il aura, elle aura, nous aurons, vous aurez, ils auront, elles auront. Okay, so one more time. J'aurai, remember, A and O together will produce this O sound, A-N-I-E, aurait, all right? Then, tu auras, final S not pronounced, aura. Il aura, elle aura, okay? Nous aurons, final S not pronounced, O and N together, nasal, on, A-U-O, auront, all right? And then, if you want to make this beautiful link, the little liaison between the two, it would be perfect, nous aurons. Okay, here, same thing here, vous aurez, all right, O, and then EZ at the end will give you this E sound, aurez, all right, and then this little link, this little liaison between the two, vous aurez, okay, then il auront, final T not pronounced, O N together, ont, auront, okay, and then the link between the two. Ils auront, elles auront. All right, so j'aurai, tu auras, il aura, elle aura, nous aurons, vous aurez, ils auront, elles auront. All right, then now for être. Je serai, tu seras, il sera, elle sera, nous serons, vous serez, ils seront, elles seront. All right, so let's see it one more time. Keep in mind that when we've got a like that, you really pronounce it so serait, okay? I together est serait. Okay, the first S is quite strong. Hein? Se serait. All right, then tu seras. Final S not pronounced. Tu seras. Il sera. Elle sera. Nous serons. So final S not pronounced. Then O-N. On seront. Vous serez. A Z together at the end. Et serez. All right. Ils seront. Final T not pronounced. And then you've got this nasal. On seront. Elles seront. All right, so one more time. Je serai, tu seras, il sera, elle sera, nous serons, vous serez, ils seront, elles seront. All right. So remember that the second part should be what we call this participe passé form. I've been making a big, big, big video concerning the participe passé. So if you really want to work on that, it will be more. Full of examples, okay? Right now, here in this video, I will only cover first here as we've got the first group, so regular ending with er, and it's quite easy because it will become e like that, okay? So, parler, er, will become parler, your participe passé form. Regarder, ending with er here, regarder, accent aigu, okay? And even this aller verb, so it doesn't belong to the first group because it's quite tricky when you come to conjugate it. But even this one is quite easy for this participe passé form because it's a accent aigu like that. Okay, so all these verbs from the first group will become parler, regarder, aller, so like that for the participe passé form. Okay, verbs from the second group, so ir, remember not all the er verbs belong to the second group, so be careful. And so examples like choisir, and it will become choisi, finir, fini, unir, uni. All right, so all these verbs will become like that, choisi, fini, uni. So this is the participe passé form, so the second part that you should put in your futur antérieur. Okay, so let's see now the third group. So it's a tricky, tricky group. So as I said, I've been making a video, and you've got more examples. But still, so main subcategories, if you want, in a way. So the one that will end with U. So like here and here. So connaître, connu. Connaître is to know. Voir, to see. Vu. Okay. Then ending with I. Partir, to leave. Parti. Rire, to laugh, ri. Then the one ending with it. Écrire, to write, écrit. Dire, to say, dit. Okay, and the one ending with es. Mettre, to put, mis. And then prendre, to take, pris. All right. An example now with parler. J'aurais parlé. Tu auras parlé. Il aura parlé, elle aura parlé, nous aurons parlé, vous aurez parlé, ils auront parlé, elles auront parlé. All right, so as we saw, first you've got this avoir at the future form, then you've got your participe passé here, okay? Aura, then participe passé, etc. So I wanted to put this accent aigu like that, just to show you that in a normal structure, so when you've got your subject and then your verb, okay, and if you conjugate it it with avoir. So it will be exactly the same rule as we had for all the composed tenses in French. You don't need to put anything at the end of your participe passé form if the structure is simple like subject and verb. All right? But if we conjugate it with être, like it is here the case with aller, aller is to go, remember, and it requires être. So what you can see is that il sera allé here. You've got the masculine and singular form, so you will put this accent aigu like that without anything. But if you've got here the feminine form, elle sera allée, you will have to add this mark of the feminine at the end of your participe passé form. Okay? You don't pronounce it, but still you need to write it. Okay? So remember, a mark of the feminine singular. If you've got the plural, like it's the case here, ils seront allés et S, like that. So you'll put this S, you don't pronounce it, but still you need to put it. Okay? Elles seront allées. Here you've got the feminine form and it's the plural, so you've got this E mark of the feminine, then you've got this S mark of the plural. Same thing here, you don't pronounce it, but you need to write it. Okay, so let's read them. Il sera allé, elle sera allée, ils seront allés, elles seront allées. All right? So let's see now how it go for the full thing. So, je serai allé. Okay, so I did put this E like that just to make it possible to put the feminine. All right? Tu seras allé. Il sera allé, elle sera allée. Nous serons allés. Vous serez allés, ils seront allés, elles seront allées. Okay, so one more time. Je serai allé, tu seras allé, il sera allé, elle sera allée. Nous serons allés, vous serez allés, ils seront allés, elles seront allées. And now we saw at the beginning of this video that all the reflexive verbs require as well être, okay, but then remember that the conjugation, it is a bit more tricky because you've got to use these me, te, etc. So let's see how they go when you put them at the futur antérieur, okay? So, je me serai présenté, tu te seras présenté, il se sera présenté, elle se sera présentée, nous nous serons présentés, vous vous serez présentés, ils se seront présentés, elles se seront présentées. Okay? So you can see that as we conjugate these verbs with être, well, it will respect exactly the same rule. So we've got to put E as the mark of the feminine when needed, S mark of the plural when needed. Here we've got nous, so it's the plural, vous as well. Okay, and then ES, like for here, elle, so feminine plural, so E and S, E for the feminine, S for the plural. Okay, so let's read them one more time. Je me serai présenté, tu te seras présenté, il se sera présenté, elle se sera présentée, nous nous serons présentés, vous vous serez présentés, ils se seront présentés, elles se seront présentées. So, keep in mind that if you want to construct this futur antérieur, it should be first avoir at the future form, then your participe passé, and you will get a beautiful futur antérieur. In some cases, être au futur plus participe passé, and then you will get your futur antérieur. I hope it was clear. If you want more videos, then youtube.com/imagier, and then more material can be found at this address, imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. les articles à la forme négative. Because it can be tricky in some cases, and I have been students who've been asking me, are they transformed? Do they stay the same if you put the sentence at the negative form? So that's what we'll see in this lesson. Okay, so we'll see first the indéfini and the partitive. Okay, so les indéfinis et les partitifs. All right, so indéfini, it would be translated as a in English, okay, and then the partitive, some something, all right, and then we will work on les articles définis, so the in English, okay, so but then first, let's see indéfini et partitif, okay, so let's see the example for the article indéfini at the masculine form, like un, for instance, and then let's see how it goes. Il a un chien. Okay, un chien, a dog, and here we've got the verb avoir. Okay, il a un chien, so a dog. Okay, so keep in mind that if you want to transform this sentence at the negative form, then il n'a pas de chien. So you can see that un here will become de here. Alright, so that's the first thing that you've got to keep in mind if you want to use these articles, so article indéfini, and you want to put the sentence like in that case at the negative form, then un will become de. Okay, so let's see the example for the feminine form now. Une. Il y a, there is, remember, une manifestation, manifestation, demonstration. Il y a une manifestation. So if we want to put this sentence at the negative form, il n'y a pas de manifestation. So you can see that this article une becomes de at the negative form. All right. So what about the plural now? Des. And then, j'achète des lunettes. Je n'achète pas de lunettes, okay? Des lunettes, glasses, acheter, to buy. J'achète des lunettes. So you can see that it will be exactly the same rule, so des becomes de, okay? So what we've got here, un is becoming de, then une is becoming de, and after that you've got des, and it's becoming de as well, okay? And this is for what we call les articles indéfinis, so a in English, okay? And then let's see now for the part, les partitifs, okay? So if you want to introduce this some, something, concept, let's see now. Je bois du café. Boire is to drink, and then when you've got this du café, well, really it's some coffee. You don't specify the quantity, so it's really what we call partitif, okay? Je bois du café. So this is the masculine form here, du. And if you look carefully, negative form, je ne bois pas de café. So you can see that du is becoming de at the negative form, all right? Second example, de la, okay, so it's for the feminine form. Elle prend. Prendre is to take de la tarte. Tarte is pie. Some, okay, would be this de la tarte. Negative form, elle ne prend pas de tarte. So you can see that this de la will become de at the negative form. All right? So what can we say if we've got un, une, or then des? So what we saw previously, so this indéfini, article indéfini, or then if we've got du, de l, or de la, as we saw previously, so what we call les partitifs, okay, if you want to put, well, them in a sentence, and the sentence is at the negative form, then you will not use them, but instead you will use de or de apostrophe, if you've got a word with a vowel after or the sound of a vowel. Okay, that's really something quite important, and you should try to remember this rule because It is quite useful, especially because we tend to use quite often. I mean, negative forms, I mean, it's not really, really rare. Okay, so it is one main rule that you should keep in mind. But of course, in French, we've got exceptions. And the exception is this structure or this form that we've got, c'est, it is, or this is. Okay, so when we use this c'est, we'll see a few examples now. Here, c'est un champion. Okay, un champion, a champion. So, c'est, this is, it is, un champion. Okay, and if you want to, well, put the same sentence at the negative form, well, look, ce n'est pas un champion. So you will keep your article as you had previously here. Un. It doesn't change. Feminine form. C'est une amie. Okay. Negative form. Ce n'est pas une amie. Feminine. It's exactly the same rule. So une will stay here. You don't modify it. And for the plural. Ce sont des produits naturels. OK. Produits, products, naturels, natural. Ce ne sont pas des produits naturels. All right. So, what can we say about that? Oh, sorry. We've got the partitive as well. So, du. So, same thing. C'est du chocolat noir. OK. Chocolate and then noir, it's black, so dark if you want. C'est du chocolat noir, okay? Négation, ce n'est pas du chocolat noir, okay? So here we've got the partitive and it's still the same here, du and du, okay? So partitive féminin, c'est de la vanille, ce n'est pas de la vanille. So de la is here and it's still here for the negative form, okay? Vanille, vanilla. All right, so now we can have the rule. So when we've got un, une, and then des, so what we saw, les articles indéfinis, or then if we've got du, de le, or de la, okay, so in that case it's the partitive. Remember that if you use them with c'est at the negative form, they will stay exactly the same. Okay, so that's the main rule that you've got to keep in mind with these articles, so indéfini or then with the partitive. If you use them in normal structures, then they will change and they will become de or des apostrophes, as we saw previously. But if you use these articles or then the partitive with c'est, in that case, they don't change when you put them at the negative form. Okay? So now we'll see the definite, so les articles définis, okay? And so we've got for the masculine le, okay? So it's the equivalent as at the in English, but then we've got the difference between the masculine, the feminine, and the plural. So le, have a look at this. Je prends le train, okay? Prendre is to take, le train, the train, okay? Je ne prends pas le train, okay? So the article doesn't change at all. You just put it back, even if it's the negative form. It doesn't change, okay? So, feminine. Elle aime la musique. Aimer is to like or to love, okay? Elle aime la musique, the music. Elle n'aime pas la musique. It doesn't change at all. Les, plural form. Nous détestons les olives noires, okay? Détester, to hate, okay? Olives, and then noir, black. Nous détestons les olives noires. Negative form, nous ne détestons pas les olives noires. Okay? In that case, it doesn't change. So you can see le doesn't change, la doesn't change, and les doesn't change either. All right, so the rule is quite simple. If you've got in your structures le, la, or les, and you want to have this structure at the negative form, then they will stay exactly the same. They won't change. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 9, Leçon F. And in this lesson, we'll discover together 108 Adjective, okay? So the list will be long, but still they are quite useful. So get ready. We're starting right now. Fâché. Okay, so remember that here, even if you get this accent circumflex on the top of A, well, technically it doesn't really change the pronunciation. Fâché. Fâcheux. So final X not pronounced, and then you get your combination of E, U, E. Fâcheux. Endormi. Remember, E-N, en. Endormi. Attractif. Réveillé. Okay, I, double L, Y, réveillé. Horrible. Okay, first letter is H, but then we don't pronounce H, so you don't pronounce it. And the first thing you hear is O, horrible. Meilleur. Okay, same thing here. I, double L, Y, meilleur. Mieux. Final X not pronounced. Grand. Final D not pronounced. Ennuyé. Okay, so first en, then nuit, then yé. Ennuyé. Ennuyeux. Okay, final X not pronounced, and then the same concept en, nuit, yeux. Ennuyeux. Courageux. Final X not pronounced, and then you get this U, E, and G plus E. After that, it's je, so je, okay? Courageux. Courageux. Génial. Calme. So don't insist on the final E. Calme. Joyeux. Final X not pronounced, and then joyeux. Okay? Joyeux. Joyeux. Nuageux. Final X not pronounced, and then G-E-U, je. Nuageux. Correct. Dangereux. Okay, so final X not pronounced, and then don't really pronounce this here. Dangereux. 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 Décidé. Malhonnête. Okay, remember, H doesn't exist, so malhonnête. Don't insist on the final E. Malhonnête. And here you get E accent circonflex, so you pronounce it like E. Malhonnête. Désorganisé. Affreux. Final X not pronounced. And then you get this fr, freux, affreux. Ennuyeux. Okay, final X not pronounced. And then ennuyeux. Ennuyeux. Facile. Excellent. Okay, you've got double L here, and then it will open the sound of your E here, and it will be E. Excellent. Excellent. Excité. Passionnant. Okay, here you pronounce the double S because you've got a vowel, so it's really a strong one. Passionnant. Final T not pronounced. And then here you get this en sound. Passionnant. Cher. Blond. Final D not pronounced. Célèbre. Okay, first you get this E. Then here you get the E. So, célèbre. Final E not really pronounced. Rapide. Favori. Final. bien. Okay, so remember, when you get this combination of I, E, N, you get the sound yin, yin, okay, and then B. Bien. En forme. Brumeux. Okay, final X not pronounced, so you get this E and then U. Brumeux. Brumeux. Free. Final T not pronounced. Free. Amical. Effrayé. Okay, remember, double F, so you open the E, so E, effrayé. And here you get this frayé, effrayé. Effrayant. Final T not pronounced. Effrayant. Amusant. Final T not pronounced. You've got only one S here between the vowels, so it's really this Z sound. A-mu-zant. Amusant. Plus loin. Beau. Okay, so remember we've got this strange combination of vowels. E, A, U, so three vowels, but then phonetically it's only O. Okay, so beau. Grillé, okay? At the end, you've got this E, and then remember, double L after E, y, y, grillé, grillé. Beau, one more time. Dur. Travailleur, okay? Remember, double L, y, y, and then E, U, R, heure. Travailleur. Travailleur. Sain. Okay? Combination of A, I, N phonetically will give you this un pronunciation. Sain. Lourd. Final D not pronounced. Honnête. Chaud. Final D not pronounced. And then when you combine this C and H, you get the sh. Sound A N U O chaud. Important. Final T not pronounced. Intelligent. Final T not pronounced. Intéressé. Intéressant. Final T not pronounced. Gentil. So it's a strange one because here this final L is not pronounced, okay? Gentil, gentil. Tard, final D not pronounced. Paresseux, final X not pronounced. Cuir. Seul. Joli. Chanceux. Final X not pronounced. And then remember, C, E, U will give you this se sound. Chanceux. Chanceux. Fou. Combination of O and U. Ou. Fou. D'âge mûr. Misérable. Okay, don't insist on the final E here. You get this bl, bl sound at the end. Okay, misé, because you've got this accent, accent aigu, rable, misérable. Nécessaire. Don't insist on the final E, nécessaire. Nerveux. Final X not pronounced. Nouveau. Remember, combination of E, A, and U together, it's O. So you get nouveau. Okay? Agréable. Don't insist on the final E. Bl. Agréable. Agréable. Normal. Ordinaire. Don't insist on the final E. Ordinaire. Organisé. E accent aigu et organisé. Obèse. Remember, E accent grave est obèse. Don't insist on the final E. Parfait. Final T not pronounced. Parfait. Parfait. Pauvre. A-U together will produce this O sound. Pauvre. Populaire. Po-pu-laire. Don't insist on the final E. Populaire. Rapide. So same thing for final E, don't insist on it, just pronounce this D. Rapide. Silencieux. Final X not pronounced, okay? This part here will be pronounced like sieux, okay? Then you get si lan sieux. Silencieux. Prêt. Final T not pronounced. E accent circonflexe like that phonetically gives you the E sound. Prêt. Détendu. E accent aigu. E. And then EN. En. Détendu. Riche. Final E not really pronounced. So SH is the last sound. Riche. Malpoli. Sûr. Accent circonflexe on the top of U, sûr. Court. Final T not pronounced. Court. Remember, when you combine this O and U together, you get the sound OU. Court. Similaire. Final E not pronounced. Similaire. Petit. Okay, remember to pronounce this E like a E. Petit. Final T not pronounced. Petit. Réussi. Okay, first you've got this E, then U and double S, so really strong S and I. Réussi. Réussi. Ensoleillé. Remember double L after I. Y. Ensoleillé. Sûr. Talentueux. Final X not pronounced. Then you get this E, U together. E, then T-U, tueux. Talentueux. Talentueux. Terrible. Terrifié. Fatigué. Okay, remember when you combine this G, U and E, you will get the G, okay? But in that case, you've got the accent, so it's G, all right? Fatigué. Fatigué. Fatigant. Okay, remember when you get G and A, you don't need to put the U between because when you combine these two letters, you get the sound G, G. So ga. Okay, in that case, you've got A and so it's gant. Final T not pronounced. Fatigant. Fatigant. Moche. Don't insist on the final E, then you get the last sound is sh. Moche. Antipathique. So remember, this H doesn't exist phonetically, so antipathique. Okay, final E, not pronounced. Antipathique. Malheureux. H doesn't exist, okay, so you get mal, e, re. Final X not pronounced. Malheureux. Malsain. A-I-N together, it's a nasal and it's un. Malsain. Méchant. Final T not pronounced, then CH, ch, chant, méchant. Inhabituel. Utile. Sho, final day not pronounced. Venteux, final X not pronounced, then EN en venteux. Pire, final E not pronounced, so R at the end, pire. Faux, okay, final X not pronounced, then you get this AU together, O, faux. Jeune, final E not pronounced, but then EU together, E, jeune, jeune. And that's it for this first list of adjectives. There was a mistake. I didn't want to stop because I was continuing. But there is one word in the list that is not, of course, an adjective, and it was leather, cuir. Okay, so probably you did correct that on your own, but then I didn't want to stop because I was in a good mood. Okay, if you want more videos, youtube.com/imagier. And then the website is here, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye-bye. And we'll see approximately 100 adjectives in the following lesson. So the idea is to give you as many adjectives as possible at this time of your learning process, because I think it's important now. Okay, so we'll start right now. Accidentel. Vivant, final T not pronounced, vivant. Ancien, remember, A-N, ancien, ancien. En colère, E accent grave like that, here you pronounce it, E, colère, en colère. Large, don't insist on the final E, large. Pieds nus. So final S here, and then final S here is not pronounced. And then when you get this combination here, it's yé, pié. Okay, so you don't hear the D. Pieds nus. Bas, final S not pronounced. Génial. Décontracté. Okay, so you get E accent aigu here and here, so it's E, décontracté, okay, décontracté. En céramique, okay, so remember this Q-U-E here will give you the sound K, okay, céramique, because you don't insist on the final E, céramique, alright, en céramique. Classique. Okay, so exactly the same thing. You don't insist on the final E, so you get K as the last sound. Classique. Côtier. Okay, so here you get this O, accent circonflexe. You tend to insist a little bit more on it, so it's a bit lower. Co, co. Okay. Côtier. Okay. I-E-R here. Yé, yé. Côtier. Froid, final D not pronounced, froid. Commun, okay, U-N, un, commun, commun. Confiant, final D not pronounced, so I-A-N, yan, fiant, confiant. Cruel, okay, remember, cruel, cruel. Dangereux, final X not pronounced, and then don't really pronounce this E here, okay, so you get dangereux, dangereux. Mort, final T not pronounced, O-R, or, mort. Décoré, okay, so E accent aigu, E accent aigu, E, décoré, décoré. Profond, final D not pronounced, O-N, on, profond. Individuel. Spectaculaire, okay, so don't insist on the final E, so l'air, spectaculaire, spectaculaire. Tôt. Okay, final did not pronounce, and then this O accent circumflex is a bit stronger than normally. So, tôt, tôt, tôt. Âgé. Okay, accent aigu here. Et âgé, âgé. Électronique. Okay, so as we saw previously, Q-U-E at the end, K. Okay, électronique, électronique, électronique. Méchant. Final T not pronounced. C-H together, sh. Méchant, méchant. Excellent. Remember, double L and E before, it will open the E, so E. Excellent, excellent. Passionnant. Final T not pronounced. Passionnant. Cher. À la mode. Final E not pronounced. À la mode. Rapide. Final E not pronounced. So rapide. Rapide. En forme. Final E not pronounced. En forme. Évasé. Remember, one S between two vowels. Z. Évasé. Courant. Final T not pronounced. A-N. En. Courant. Folk. Fragile. Okay, final E not pronounced. And then when you get this G and I, J. Gilles. Fragile. Amical. Effrayant. Okay, so final T not pronounced. And then you get effrayant. Okay. Effrayant. Gelé. Amusant. Final T not pronounced. Content. Final T not pronounced. So E-N. En as well. Content. Content. Amical. Dur. Utile. Final E not pronounced. So utile. Horrible. Okay, remember we don't pronounce H here. Horrible. Immense. Final E not pronounced. Immense. Important. So final T not pronounced. And then remember you've got this EM and after that it's a consonant. So it is here nasal. Un. Important. Important. Indépendant. Final T not pronounced. Indépendant. Indépendant. Informel. Intelligent. Final T not pronounced. So G-E-N. Jean. Ok. Intelligent. Double L. It opens the pronunciation of your E. So it's E. Intelligent. Intéressant. Double S, same thing here. S, strong, and it opens the pronunciation of your E. Intéressant. Final T not pronounced. Humain, remember. H is not pronounced. A-I-N, un. Humain. En direct. Logique. Remember, Q-U-E at the end. K. Logique. Bas, final S not pronounced. À taille basse. Okay, so basse, final N not pronounced, but then you pronounce the double S, so S, basse. And then here you get the double L after your I, remember, I. Taille, à taille basse. Chanceux, final X not pronounced. This C-E-U, ce, chanceux, chanceux. Deluxe. Mathématiques. Remember, H doesn't exist, so mathématiques. Remember, Q-U-E at the end, K. Mathématiques. Médical. Mémorable. Don't insist on the final E. Mémorable. Négligé. Okay, accent aigu here and here. Et négligé. Négligé. D'âge mûr. Minimum. Nerveux. Final X not pronounced. E-U, E, V. Nerveux. Bruyant. Final T not pronounced. So you get bruyant. Ok. Bruyant. Bruyant. Hors ligne. Final E here not pronounced. So ligne. And then here S is not pronounced. The final one. So hors. And remember H doesn't exist. So hors ligne. En ligne. Okay, so here, en ligne. En plein air. All right, so you've got this air here, and then we tend to make the liaison plein air, plein air. En plein air. Douloureux. Remember, final X not pronounced, so you get this OU together, ou douloureux. Douloureux. Populaire, final and not pronounced, so populaire, populaire. Psychologique, okay, remember it's an exception here because you've got this C-H-O. Normally we should pronounce it CHO, okay, but in that case we pronounce it CO. Psychologique, remember, final Q-U-E like that, K. Psychologique. Silencieux, final X not pronounced. Radioactif. Enregistré, okay. So here, final E with the accent, so E, okay. T-R-E, accent grave, c'est, accent aigu, it's très, alright. So, enregistré, okay. But then, you don't really insist on this E. Enregistré, enregistré, détendu, okay, so E-N-N, détendu, détendu, renouvelable, look, renouvelable, remember, bl, bl at the end, but then this E here is not really pronounced, so renouvelable. Renouvelable. Okay, it's a bit tricky, I know, but try your best. Renouvelable. Romantique. Remember, Q-U-E at the end, K. Romantique. Royal. Okay, so, same thing with this Y. Royal. 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 Sûr. Effrayé. Mitoyen. Okay, same thing with the Y that we had here with effrayé and royal. Royal, sorry. So, mitoyen. Mitoyen. Peu profond. Final D not pronounced. Peu profond. Mince. Okay, mince. Irrité. Droit. So final T, not pronounced. Stressé. Okay, remember you've got double S here, so you pronounce it really strong. Well, it's between two vowels. So C, All right, and then here you get this e before the double s, so it will open the pronunciation of the e. Est stressé, stressé, stressant. Okay, final tenor pronounce, and then a n en, stressant. Fort, final tenor pronounced. Réussi, okay, réussi, réussi. Bronzé, so on, on, and then z, so we pronounce like z, bronzé, bronzé. Superstitieux, okay, so final x not pronounced, superstitieux, okay, remember when we get this t after e and then e here, s, superstitieux, superstitieux. En mitoyenneté. Okay, so mitoyenneté. En mitoyenneté. Terrifiant. Final tenor pronounce. Double R here, so it will open the pronunciation of your E, and then it will be E. Terrifiant. Résistant. Final tenor pronounced. Résistant. Tropical, sous-marin, okay, so en here, un, rin, marin, all right, and remember, sous, okay, final s not pronounced, so s-o-u, sous, sous-marin. Utile, final u not pronounced, utile. Verbal. Visuel. Remember it's E here and L. UEL. UEL. Visuel. So this would be a list of 120 adjectives. Okay. And it will complete the whole adjective series that I wanted to introduce at this point of our learning process. Okay. So let's start now. Alarmant. Final T not pronounced. Ambitieux, final X not pronounced, and then remember that you've got this T, I, and then vowel, so C. Ambitieux, ambitieux. Amusé, okay, E, accent aigu at the end, so E, Z, amusé. En colère, okay, remember, E, accent grave, E, and then R, okay, you don't insist on the E. Colère, en colère. Artificiel. Athlétique. Okay, remember that H doesn't exist. So, athlétique. Remember, Q-U-E at the end, K. Athlétique. Athlétique. Réveillé. Okay, so accent aigu here and here, so E, then you get E, I, E, and then double L, Y, Y, réveillé, réveillé. Mal payé, okay, remember when you get this Y and two vowels, so payé, payé, mal payé. Irritable, don't insist on the final E. Aveugle, same thing, final E, not really present. So, aveugle, gl, aveugle. Bouillant, final T not pronounced. A and together, remember, nasal, en, okay. And then here you get bou, alright. And after that you get this yan, okay. Bouillant, bouillant. Autoritaire, so final E, not here, autoritaire, autoritaire. Courageux, final X not pronounced, G-E-U together, they will give you this jeu, okay, courageux, courageux. large d'épaule, final S not pronounced, large, final E here not pronounced, d'épaule. Enterré. Okay, remember, N together, nasal, en, and then you get this double R here, and it will open the sound of the E, okay? Enterré. Enterré. Épais. Final S not pronounced, R-E together, E, et, épais. Épais. Calme. Final E, not here. Stimulant, final T not pronounced, stimulant, stimulant. Circulaire, final E not pronounced, I together, it's E, okay, so R, circulaire, circulaire. Rasé de près, final S not pronounced, okay, so here you get the E accent grave, E, près, okay. Here, E accent aigu, et rasé. Rasé de près. Confiant. Okay, final T not pronounced. So, O-N, on, I-A-N, yan, confiant. Confiant. Attentionné. Okay, at the end, you've got this E accent aigu, so, et, a, tant, so remember, E-N, en, temps, sio, né, attentionné. Contemporain. Okay, so I-N at the end, un. E-M here, because it followed by a consonant here, you get this P, so it will be a nasal, so it will be en. And here, another nasal, on. Con, temps, po, rein, contemporain. Condamné. Okay, so it's really strange because this M here, well, technically it's not pronounced. Condamné. Okay, condamné. Effrayant. Okay, remember, final T not pronounced. Effrayant. Effrayant. Coupé court. Final T not pronounced. And here you get this E accent aigu. Coupé court. Fâché. Remember, C and H together. Ch-ch. And then E, ché. Fâché. Cruel. Okay. U here. Cru. Cruel. Actuel. Actuel. Elle, actuelle. Mignon. Okay. Here in that case, G-N-O-N, nion. Mignon. Sourd. Final D not pronounced. O-U together. Ou sourd. Ferme. Okay. Final E not pronounced. Ferme. Décoratif, ok, E accent aigu, et décoratif, décoratif. Déprimé. Désert, ok, remember, final T not pronounced, désert. And really this z sound just because you get one S between the two vowels, ok, z, désert. Décider. Ok, remember, accent aigu here and here, so et décider. Décider. Électronique. Ok, so que at the end, remember, Q-U-E at the end. Que. Électronique. Électronique. Émouvant. Final T not pronounced. A-N together. En et mou vent. Émouvant. En voie d'extinction. En voie, final E not pronounced, d'extinction. Okay, remember, T-I-O-N, sion. extinction. Extinction. En voie d'extinction. Énorme. Final unpronounced. Énorme. Énorme. Entier. So remember, I-E-R, yé, yé, ok, and then the T, tié, and the nasal before, en, entier. Éternel, ok, so E accent aigu, éternel, éternel. Épuisé, ok, remember, you've got two E accent aigu, épuisé. Épuisé. Disparu. Fidèle. Final E, not pronounced. So, E, accent grave here. L, L. Fidèle. Fidèle. Fantastique. OK. Q-U-E at the end. K. OK. Tic. Fantastique. Fantastique. Fascinant, final T not pronounced, so you get this A-N, en, non, fa, si, non. Imaginaire, final E not pronounced, imaginaire, imaginaire. Étranger, you remember E-R at the end, et. So, after that, well, before that, sorry. G, G, so, étranger, étranger. Glacial. Frustré. À temps complet. A, okay, so even if you've got an accent, it doesn't change the pronunciation of your A, okay, so it's A. And then, temps. Okay, so in that case, it's only the nasal here that you will hear, temps, okay, because the P is not pronounced and the S is not pronounced. Temps, and then complet, okay, here ET at the end will open it, open, sorry, the sound of the E, so E, okay, plet, complet, complet, and then OM is nasal here, just because you get your P after that, so it's on, complet. À temps complet. À temps complet. Furieux. Okay, final X not pronounced. Furieux. Furieux. Génétique. Remember, k. Génétique. Coupable. Final U not pronounced. Coupable. Coupable. Sain. All right, so final T not pronounced, and then when you combine this A, E, N here, you get the N sound, sain, sain. Honnête. So remember, H doesn't exist. Honnête. Horrifié. Same thing here, you don't pronounce the H. Horrifié. Exalté. Okay, so here, final E with the accent, so E, exalté. Humain, remember, H doesn't exist, so U, then A, E, N together, un, humain, humain. Hypnotique, remember, at the end, Q, E, K, tic. So H is not pronounced. Hypnotique. Hypnotique. Illégal. Illogique. Remember, k, k, ik. Illogique. Ingénieux. Final X not pronounced, so I-E-U, ye, nieux. Ingénieux. Ingénieux. Impatient. Okay, remember, final T not pronounced, and then you've got this T, I, and a vowel, so sian, sian, impatient, impatient. Impoli, Okay, remember EM and then a consonant after, so nasal, un, impoli. Impossible. Don't insist on the final E. Impossible. Incroyable. Okay, same thing here for the final E. Don't pronounce it. So, incroyable. 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 Indépendant. Final T not pronounced. Pas cher. Informel. Insensible. Okay, final un not pronounced. Insensible. Insensible. Irrégulier. Okay, remember IER at the end of your word here, it will be IE, okay? Irrégulier. Irrégulier. Irresponsable. Don't pronounce the final E. Bl, bl will be the last sound. Sable. Irresponsable. Légal. Deluxe. Final E not pronounced. Insignifiant. Okay, final T not pronounced. So you've got this I-A-N, I-A-N, so F before, fiant. Insigni, okay, remember, G-N-I, ni, ni, insignifiant, insignifiant. Mineur, E-U-R, heure, mineur, mineur. Mythique, remember, Q-U at the end, k, okay, and then Y is pronounced like I, mi, H is not pronounced, T, mythique, d'origine, nomade, final un not pronounced, officiel, paranoïaque, okay, remember, Q-U-E-C-A-C, paranoïaque, paranoïaque, pacifique, Q-U-E-C-I-C, pacifique. Potelé. Okay, here you don't really pronounce this E. Potelé. Potelé. Psychologique. Okay, remember at the end you've got this K. Okay, so I-C and then Y is pronounced like I. Psi. And then it's an exception here because normally we should pronounce it Show, okay, but then we pronounce it co. Psychologique. Psychologique. Raisonnable. Remember, I together est. Raisonnable. Distant. Final T not pronounced. Distant. Gratifiant. Same thing here. Final T not pronounced. Gratifiant. Rythmique, remember, Y pronounced like I and then H doesn't exist. Rythmique, rythmique. En ruine, don't pronounce the final E, ruine. Sacré, accent aigu at the end, et sacré. Autosuffisant, final T not pronounced. Autosuffisant. Autosuffisant. Sensé. Final E, accent aigu, et sensé. Sensible. Okay. Final E not pronounced. Bl will be the last sound. Sensible. Similaire. So final E not pronounced. Okay. Similaire. L'air. Mince. Final E not pronounced. I-N together. Un. Mince. Lisse. Double S here, so it's really a strong S. Lisse. Okay, don't insist on the final E. Lisse. stressant, final denote pronouns, are end together en and then double s, sans, and it will open the pronunciation of your e, so e. Stressant, stressant. Chic, okay, you pronounce the final c, and then ch together, sh, chic. De banlieue, okay, final unnote pronounce, so i-e-u, ie, l, lieu, banlieue, de banlieue. Très petit, final denote pronounce, and then e is pronounced like a e, petit, très petit. Here, final s doesn't exist, it's not pronounced. Très petit, très petit. Traditionnel, okay, so you get double n here, traditionnel, onel, onel, traditionnel. Transatlantique, okay, so at the end, tic, remember, q-u-e-k, okay. Transatlantique, transatlantique. Tribal. Tropical. Sans peur, okay, pronounce the final R, E-U-R, heur, peur. Sans peur. Don't pronounce the final S here. Sans peur. Inconfortable. Okay. Don't pronounce final E. Table. Inconfortable. Inconfortable. Au chômage. Remember, CH together. Ch. Chaud. Chômage. Au chômage. Malchanceux. Final X not pronounced, C-E-U, ce, malchanceux, malchanceux. Peu utile, final U not pronounced, peu utile. Désagréable, final U not pronounced, bl at the end, désagréable, désagréable. Peu réaliste, don't insist on the final E. Peu réaliste. Intact. Intact. Peu sûr. Affecté. Ondulé. Riche. Okay, remember, C-H-E, ch. So, sh, normally, but then you don't insist on the final e, so, sh, riche. Solide, same thing here, don't insist on the final e, solide. Bien payé, okay, remember, final e, accent aigu, et, okay, payé, payé, all right, payé. And then, i-e-n, yin, bien payé, bien payé. Les prépositions avec les articles. So it will be, actually it will be the first step into this big, big, big thing that we will do concerning the preposition, les prépositions, because it's quite important in French. And then I thought it might be important to, well, work on them at this point of our learning process. Okay, so first here in this video we'll work on a and then de, and especially when you combine these two prepositions with articles. So we'll see first the indefinite, so les articles indéfinis, un, une, des, okay, and after that we'll see les articles définis, le, la, les, okay, and especially we'll concentrate on the way these prepositions will react in a way when they are combined with these articles, okay. So the first one that we will discover together will be a, okay, and so we'll see avec les articles définis. So remember, les articles définis, it would be translated in English as a something, okay, but then in French we've got the difference between the masculine form, so it's un, the feminine form it's une, and the plural form, it's des. Okay, so let's see now. I've been making few examples. So I did take this parler verb to talk because it's quite interesting. You can use it with the preposition à to talk to, okay? And it's also possible to use it with the preposition de to talk about something, okay? So that's the reason why I wanted to use this verb, just to show you that, well, basically it's possible to use two prepositions if you want to express something different, and then just to see how it will change if you put an article after that. So the first sentence, je parle à un homme. Okay, un homme, a man. Je parle à un homme. Okay, I talk to a man. So in that case, what you can see is that you keep your preposition à here, right after the verb, and then you put your article and basically nothing happens. Okay, je parle à un homme. So let's see an example with the feminine. Je parle à une femme. Okay, une femme, a woman. Je parle à une femme. Same thing here. Nothing happens. So it's actually quite easy. And then have a look here. Je parle à des amis. All right. Je parle à des amis. Same thing here. You've got your preposition and then you've got the article. So un masculin, une, des. Okay, so the good news is that if you use this preposition à, and after that you put this article indéfini, un, une, des, nothing will happen. No modification, no changes, you just keep them like that. Okay, let's see now if you want to put this article défini. Okay, remember, article défini, if you want to translate that in English, it would be the something, okay, but then as usual in French we've got the difference between the masculine form, le, the feminine form, la, and the plural form, les. Okay, so remember, masculine, le, feminine, la, and then the plural, les. Okay, so let's have a look now. If we keep, well, the same verb, as I said, you know, je parle, parler, to talk, and in that case, you can have a look and you can see that it's been changing a little bit, okay? So à plus le will become o, like that. You write it au, you pronounce it o, okay? Je parle au directeur. Directeur, translation, director, okay? Je parle au directeur. Let's see the feminine form. Je parle à la directrice, okay, directrice, director, but the feminine form, okay, je parle à la directrice. So here you can see that, well, nothing happens, so you still have your preposition à, and then you've got your article here, okay, so nothing changes when you've got the feminine form. And let's see the plural form now, so you've got the directors, so it's the plural form, je parle au directeur. Okay, so you can see that here you combine a plus les and you will get this aux, okay, and then phonetically you produce it or you pronounce it o. Okay, so here o, masculine form, plural form, o as well. And for your information, it could be, so I did put this directeur here, okay, it could be directrice, so it could be the feminine plural, it wouldn't change anything because it will be still this O. Okay, so it will be for the masculine or the feminine plural, it will be AUX O. Alright, so je parle au directeur. So here for the masculine, je parle à la directrice. Here for the feminine, je parle au directeur for the plural. Alright, so if we want to make it clear, then we can say that A plus le will become O, okay, then A plus la, well, will stay the same, A la, it doesn't change at all, and then A plus les will become O, A-U-X, but then remember that phonetically it's O. Okay, so that's the main thing that you should remember if we talk about this preposition are combined with the article, les articles définis here. Okay? And now let's have a look at de. So exactly the same thing. We'll see how de will react. So first, avec les articles indéfinis. Okay, so un, une, and then de. Alright. So I took this parler again. Okay. So, but that keep in mind that if we've got this parler and then we use the preposition de, then it's to talk about something. Alright. So here, je parle d'un homme. Alright. So normally we should have here de un homme, but well, as you know, we've been seeing that quite often now. It's not a new thing. Remember that a here will disappear, and then you will put this little apostrophe d'un homme. Okay, je parle d'un homme. All right, but then the thing is that no major modification will be done because you just keep your de. Well, the e needs to disappear, but then still you've got your article. Okay. Je parle d'une personne. Okay. Une personne, a person. Je parle d'une personne. So exactly the same thing here. Nothing major happens. Only this e, you know, disappear. But then that's the only thing that you should remember to do if you want to combine the two. All right. The tricky thing is here when you want to combine de and de. Alright, just because we think that it would sound strange to have this de, des, romans. Okay, so the thing that will disappear will be the article. Okay, so that's the reason why we get this je parle de romans. Alright, so in that case, des will be taken away. Alright, so remember, de plus un will become d'un. De plus une will become d'une. De plus des will become de. Okay, so you will have to take this des away. Alright, so let's see now how it will work if we combine it with les articles définis. So le, la, and les. Okay, as we saw previously. Let's see now the examples. The first one, je parle du voisin. Voisin, here it's the masculine form of the neighbor. Le voisin, okay, the neighbor. And what you can see here is, well, the result of the combination of de plus le, okay? It will become du, okay, for the masculine form. Je parle du voisin, okay? So I talk about the neighbor. So let's see now how it will go. So I kept this neighbor, but then here it's the feminine form, so it's la voisine, all right? And what you can see here, je parle de la voisine, well, it will stay the same. So you keep your preposition, de, and then you put your article, la, and you put your name, or your word, sorry, voisine, okay? Je parle de la voisine. Nothing happens here. And it's a good thing. And then for the plural, as we had for a, remember, well, for the masculine singular and the plural, changes will happen. So, je parle des voisins. Here we've got the plural form of voisins, so neighbors, all right? Je parle des voisins. So remember, masculine, du, feminine, de la, and then the plural form, plural, whether it's masculine or feminine, it will be the same, okay? So, de. Okay? So, let's write it like that. De plus le will become du. De plus la will stay the same. Nothing happens. De la. And then de plus le will become de. La préposition a. Okay, so in the previous lesson, I've been introducing the modification of this preposition a when it's combined with articles. Okay, so I would definitely advise you to watch it if you didn't. And then in that lesson, we'll discover, well, the different uses of la préposition Ah, and you'll see that it's a long video. Why? Just because ah could mean or could be translated in English with at, in, to, and then I explain you the reason why we've got this second to here, because it will be the from something to something. Okay, so that's the main reason why we've got the two to-dos. And then it could be translated with on, and then other meanings and other uses of this preposition a. Okay, so we'll start with at, if that's okay with you. And so, few examples. The first one, so if you want to translate it with this at, would be il reste à la maison. Rester is to stay, okay? And in that case, we would construct it with a, okay? Il reste, he stays à la maison, at home, okay? Il reste à la maison. Second example, we could use this conduire, okay? Conduire is to drive, and then when you want to introduce the speed, okay? In that case, it's 40 kilometer heure, then you would use this à, okay? So at 40 kilometers per hour. Je conduis à 40 kilometer heure. Je conduis à 40 kilometer heure. Okay? And then the last example we could have for this at, it's for the price, like here, à 10 euros. Le prix, the price, est fixé, okay, à 10 euros. Okay, so in that case, it would be translated by this at, but then in that case, well, here we would use this à in French. Okay, so il reste à la maison. Je conduis à 40 km heure. Le prix est fixé à 10 euros. Okay, so if you want to express this at concept for these situations, then you will have to use this preposition à. Okay, so let's see now the second category we will have, and it will be this in concept. So the first one, mon frère est au lit. Okay, mon frère, my brother, is au lit, in bed. Lit's bed. Okay, mon frère est au lit. Second example, il est à la campagne. Campagne, country, countryside. Okay, il est à la campagne. All right, so in that case, it will be used, I mean, we will use this preposition à. Okay? And then the last one, so if you want to introduce a town, okay, you want to use this habiter, habiter is to live, okay? J'habite à Paris. All right, you can see we don't put any articles, just the name of the town. J'habite, I live in Paris. J'habite à Paris. All right, so mon frère est au lit, il est à la campagne, j'habite à Paris. Okay, so if you want to, well, translate this in concept that would be in English, then it should be à with, as we saw, the combination with the articles, if needed, and the modification, au lit, à la campagne, à Paris. All right, let's see another use of a, and it would be to. Few examples. Je rentre à la maison. Okay, so in that case, rentrer, it's to go back. All right, so je rentre à la maison. And when we want to introduce this concept, then we should use this à la maison. Je rentre à la maison. Second thing. Nous allons, allons is to, aller is to go, okay, à Marseille. Nous allons à Marseille. Okay, so we go to, all right, so in that case, you should use this préposition à. All right, then, il donne un conseil, okay, donner is to give, un conseil, an advice, okay, so he gives an advice à sa fille, his daughter. So in that case, to his daughter, you should use also this préposition à. Okay? So je rentre à la maison. Nous allons à Marseille. Il donne un conseil à sa fille. All right? And so now, whoops, we'll see the second use of this to, okay? But when it's combined with the preposition de, like here. So de would be from, and then you put something, and a will be the to. All right? So je travaille, travail is to work, de, so from, 8 heures à 17 heures. Okay, so it's really the from to. Okay, so in this example, it's quite traditional, quite classic, because we introduce the hours or the time. Okay, so from to. Let's see another example now. Il sera, remember, sera, it's to be, but the future form. Il sera en France du 15 juin. Okay, so here you've got a date, and if you look carefully, you've got this du. So it does mean that normally you should put the article le 15 juin, and that's the reason why we've been combining the two, and it becomes du. Okay, we've been seeing that in a previous lesson, so if it's not clear, watch it. Du 15 juin au, same thing here, we've got the preposition à, but then combined with the same article, so le, okay, and it will become au 22 juillet. All right, so in that situation, you can see that it's exactly the same concept, but as we use the articles, then we've got to modify the prepositions. Okay, so il sera en France du 15 juin au 22 juillet. And the last example that we can have, ce train, this train, okay, va, so goes, de Rennes à Paris. Okay, and in that case, we just put the name of the towns, okay, de Rennes à Paris. But then in that case, so whether it's à 17 heures, au 22 juillet, à Paris, so the concept is it's this to, okay, but then it is combined with de, and then remember de with the articles, and it will change, so in that case it would be to. All right? Another possibility would be the concept of this on. Okay, so let's see a few examples here. Ce film, this movie, est à la télé. Okay, on TV, à la télé. Okay, we've got this à here, and then la télé. So télé, of course, it's for télévision. Okay, but in most of the cases, we don't use in French this télévision, the full word. We just use this télé word, okay? Ce film est à la télé. Second example. Mon ami, my friend, habite is to live, au, so same thing here, you've got this preposition, but it's combined with le, so it becomes au, and then cinquième étage. Cinquième, fifth, and then étage, floor. So in that case, you want to say that your friend is living on the fifth floor, okay? And in that case, we get to use this à preposition. Third example, il y a une horloge, okay, a clock, au mur, okay, so same thing here, okay, le mur, the wall, okay, but then we combine a and le and it becomes au, okay, au mur. Il y a une horloge au mur. So let's read them one more time. Ce film est à la télé, mon ami habite au cinquième étage, il y a une horloge au mur. All right? And now, let's see all the other possibilities that we've got, okay? So, with verbs, because some verbs, and it's only examples here, because we've got many verbs that will require this preposition à, okay? So, parler à, to talk to, penser à, okay, to think about someone or something, arriver à, okay, to succeed, to do something, okay? So in that case, you should use this preposition à with these verbs, okay? You will see that normally the way students do is that they will remember these prepositions and the combination of verbs and prepositions little by little. So when you will encounter a new verb with a preposition, the idea is to try to write it or to try to memorize it, and that's the way it will go. Okay, so same thing, you can combine this preposition a with adjectives. For instance, interdit a, or then prêt à. Interdit, it's forbidden, prêt, ready. Okay, so in that case, you should combine these adjectives with the preposition à. Okay? So it's possible to use this preposition à when you want to express or to tell how it is done. Okay? So for instance, when you want to say that it's been done, it's been machine done, or hand, how do you say, handmade? Yeah, you use this fait. So faire is to do, okay, but then in that case it would be done, okay. À la machine, fait à la main. All right. Second use, when you want to use this travel concept. So venir is to come, okay. So if you want to say that, well, to come by something, okay. Here it's pied, foot, vélo, and then motorbike, okay? So the concept in French is that if you're not inside, so like a car, a train, tramway, subway, so if you're not inside, then normally the concept would be to use this preposition à, okay? When you want to use this come, go, okay, by. So you should use this à preposition, okay? But then keep in mind that in many cases, French people tend to use, when it comes to vélo, moto, well, you can listen and you can hear quite many times this en instead of a. Not really for pied, because, well, French people will still use this à pied, okay, because it's like a common expression. But still for vélo and moto, many persons will use this en. Okay, officially it should be a mistake, but then many persons are using it, so just be ready and try to remember that it's possible that you will hear this en vélo, en moto, okay. If you want to describe something, okay, so for instance, la personne au manteau vert, okay, so in that case you want to say that this is the person who is wearing the green jacket, okay, au manteau vert, so in that case it's always the same, so a and le combine and it will become au, or then, you know, in that case it can be red hair, okay, so cheveux roux, so in that case it's the plural, okay, a plus les, and it will become au, like that. But it's quite common to use this à, okay, and then you want to describe a person. So it's also quite commonly used if you want to talk about food, for instance, un gâteau au chocolat. Alright, so un gâteau au chocolat, same thing here, à le, okay, un gâteau au chocolat, or then un croissant aux amandes. Un croissant aux amandes. So gâteau, cake, chocolat, chocolate. Croissant, it's this classical French pastry. And then amande, almonds. Okay? And then the use. So, for instance, if you want to make a difference between, because une cuillère, it's a spoon. Okay? So coffee spoon will be une cuillère à café. Alright? So in that case, we've got to use this preposition à as well. Or then une machine à laver, washing machine, so une machine à laver. Another option would be the owner, so if you want to say la maison, so the house est à mon frère, okay, so belongs to my brother, so in that case we use this être, to be, okay, and then à here, mon frère, my brother. Okay, well then you could say ce chien, this dog, is mine. So est is à moi. So it's possible, like we've been seeing here, to put a noun after, or then you could put a pronoun, like here, à moi, or then you could put the name of the person. C'est à Eric, okay, does it belong to Eric? C'est à Eric? So it's a question in that case, all right? it's quite commonly used, this when you want to say that the person is owning the thing. Okay, and then the time. So if you want to use this rendez-vous, so let's meet à 20h. Okay, so in that case, you should use this à, and then you put the time à 8h du matin, for instance. The pain. Normally, we've got this expression. So when you say that, when you want to say that, well, you've got an ache, something somewhere in your body. So avoir mal, and then à, all right? And then you will combine it with the article. So ventre would be like stomach, okay? So stomach ache would be avoir mal au ventre. So obviously this O is à plus le. So that's the reason why it's like that, okay? Ventre is masculine. So if it's tête, la tête, head, headache, à la tête, okay? So same structure, avoir mal à la tête. And then, in that case, pied, foot, au pied, okay? Avoir mal au pied. Okay, so in that case, you get the plural form. And the last thing that we'll use this preposition à for, it's when you want to say goodbye. So if you notice that probably we say à demain, so see you tomorrow, à demain, à bientôt, bientôt soon, see you soon, à tout à l'heure, so it's in a few minutes or in a while, à tout à l'heure, okay, à demain, à bientôt, à tout à l'heure, so in that case you should definitely use this preposition à if you want to say these things. La préposition de, okay, so in the previous lesson it was la préposition à, and the lesson before it was the combination of these two prepositions when you've got articles after, so if you didn't watch them, please do, it will be more easy for you. So let's start now, la préposition de, so we'll see the different uses that we can have of this préposition de, and especially the meaning in English, okay, so the first use that we could have or we could spot for this preposition de is the partitive, so in French, partitif, okay, so a few examples here, il boit du café, okay, boire is to drink, du café, café, coffee, and then here, well, we've got the partitive form, so it's some coffee, okay, and then remember that we've got the preposition de, but then when it's combined with this le, it becomes du, okay, that's the partitive form, il boit du café. And then other example, sorry, second example, elle prend de la salade, okay, prendre is to take, de la salade, some salad, okay, so elle prend de la salade, okay, first use of this preposition de, it's this partitive concept, all right, second use will be the translation of from in English, okay, so a few examples, je viens de Paris, venir is to come, I come from Paris, okay, so in that case really this de would be translated with from, okay, un appel, so appel is a call, de ma mère, from my mother, okay, so it's exactly this from concept in English, okay, so let's see now another possibility, when you want to introduce this belonging concept, okay, then usually you should use this preposition de, like here, l'ordinateur de Samuel, okay, so with this structure you want to say that l'ordinateur, the computer, belongs to Samuel, all right, so in that case you should use this de, so it's quite simple because you just put the word, well, the noun, and after that you put this de and the name of the person, okay, it could be also like here, la voiture, the car, of the neighbor, in that case, yeah, du voisin, voisin is the neighbor, okay, and then, well, in that case, if you look carefully, you've got the preposition de combined with the article le, the neighbor, okay, and it becomes du, all right. Other possibility, l'ami, the friend, de mon père, okay, my father, of my father. So it's really this belonging, something or someone is belonging in a way to something or someone as well. Okay, so l'ordinateur de Samuel, la voiture du voisin, l'ami de mon père. Okay? So let's see now another possibility of the use of la préposition de when you want to introduce this containing concept. Like here, for instance, une boîte, a box, de chocolat. Okay, so inside the box you've got chocolates, okay, and then une boîte de chocolat. Okay, so the use of de in that case it's quite clear. It's just because les chocolats sont contenus dans la boîte. Une boîte, une bouteille d'eau. Okay, bottle of water. Okay, and so in that case you should use this de. Okay, but then obviously because you've got first here a vowel. Okay, they don't really get along. So as usual in French, disappear, and you get this apostrophe. Une bouteille d'eau, okay, une bouteille, bottle, eau, water, a bottle of water. Une boîte de chocolat, une bouteille d'eau, okay, so in that case, definitely you should use this préposition de, okay. So if you want to introduce the fact that it's made of something, then, for instance here, un rideau, so rideau is curtain, and then de lin. Lin is linen. Un rideau de lin. Okay. Second example. Une chaise, a chair, de bois. Bois is wood, of wood. Okay. So in that case, un rideau de lin, une chaise de bois. So when you want to introduce the fact that these things are made of something, then you will have to use this préposition de. Okay. And then the use. For instance here, une station de métro. Une station de métro. Other possibility, une place de parking. Yeah, sorry about that, but well, French people tend to use this parking as well. So I know it's coming from English, but still you should pronounce it the French way. Parking. Une place de parking. Okay. And the last one, un studio d'enregistrement. Okay. Enregistrement is recording. Un studio d'enregistrement. So as you can see in that case, as usual in French, as we saw previously, we've got this de, but then as enregistrement is starting with a vowel, then e needs to go away. Okay. So une station de métro, une place de parking, un studio d'enregistrement. Okay, so that's this use concept. So what you use these things for? Okay, so une place de parking, un studio d'enregistrement. Normally, we tend to use as well this préposition de when we combine or when we use these superlatives things. So, for instance, here, le plus beau film de tous les temps, of all time. Okay, so le plus beau, okay, most beautiful, beau is beautiful, film, movie, de tous les temps, of all times. Le plus beau film de tous les temps. Okay, and then la plus grande, grande, big, avenue du monde. And in that case, you can see that you combine this de and then the article le monde, the world, okay? De le becomes du, okay? So du monde of the world. La plus grande avenue du monde. Okay, so for all these superlatives constructions, then remember you will have to use this préposition de, okay? De tous les temps, du monde. And so keep in mind that it's also possible to combine, and some adjectives will require this préposition de, as we had previously. Some adjectives will require the préposition a. Okay, and it will be exactly the same with de. So, for instance, étonné, astonished, then we put de. Okay, content, happy, de. Désolé, sorry, de. Okay, so as I said, and it will come after that for the verbs, try to remember them when you encounter them or when you read them, okay? That's the only way to really remember them. So, and for the verbs, exactly the same thing. So, parler de, remember, we had the example with parler. So, parler à, to talk to. Parler de, to talk about something. So, parler de, for instance. S'excuser de, okay, to excuse oneself, s'excuser. Promettre, to promise, de. Okay, so these verbs will be constructed with the preposition de. La préposition en. Okay, so remember, previous lesson we saw la préposition de. The lesson before it was la préposition en. And in the next lesson, we'll discover, well, quite many other prepositions. Okay, so let's start with la préposition en right now. So la préposition en can be used to express this to concept in English. For instance, je vais en ville, okay, I like to go, and then ville is town, okay, so je vais en ville, or then nous voyageons, voyager is to travel, en Espagne, Spain. Okay, so in that case, when you want to, well, express this to concept in English, in many cases, we'll use this en preposition, okay? Other use could be this in. For instance, j'habite en Finlande. Habiter is to live, okay? I live in Finland. J'habite en Finlande. Je fais l'exercice en 5 minutes, okay? So, I do, okay, faire is to do, l'exercice, the exercise, in 5 minutes. Okay, so in that case, and it's quite important, when you use this in, so en here, it will mean the time you need to make the exercise. Okay, so you don't want to express that you will do that in 5 minutes, so after 5 minutes, but really, if you use this preposition en, in that case, it is to express the time that you need to make this exercise. All right, so in, like that, en Finlande, and then en 5 minutes. Let's see now for the countries. So in many cases, we'll have, so as we saw in a previous lesson, we've got the difference for the countries between the masculine, the feminine, and the plural countries. Okay, so in many cases, when the country is ending with this vowel en here, okay, here, it will mean that it is feminine, okay? We've got exceptions, of course, because French language is quite tricky, so we've got exceptions like Mexique, for instance, it's masculine, okay? But in many cases, it will mean that it's feminine. If it's feminine, then you will have to use this preposition en if you want to express this in concept. Okay, en France, en Espagne, en Allemagne, en Italie. Okay, and now we'll read it with the liaison if needed. En France, en Espagne, en Allemagne, en Italie. Okay, so if you want to express this in with countries and only feminine countries, then you should use this en preposition, okay? And then when we're talking about the seasons, well, we've got 4 seasons, and as usual in French, we need to have one exception, okay? But then for the 3 others, it will be en, okay? En été, so in summer, été is summer, then en automne, okay, autumn, and then en hiver, okay, make the little liaison here, en hiver, hiver is winter, au printemps, okay, so keep in mind that for printemps, you will have to use au and not en, okay, and then printemps is spring, okay, en été, en automne, en hiver, au printemps, all right. Another use of this preposition en is to express the mean of transport, and then if you want to say I'm coming with my car, by car, okay, in French we will use this preposition en, okay, je viens, venir is to come, je viens, I come, okay, by car, en voiture, Tu voyages en train. Okay, and well, we saw in the lesson when we saw this préposition a, we saw that for pied, for instance, foot, and then we saw that motorcycle, moto, and then bicycle, vélo. In these cases, we use the preposition a. Okay, but then keep in mind that, well, let's say that the main difference is if you want to use this en preposition, normally we tend to use it if we express or if we introduce after that mean of transport that will mean that you will be inside it. Okay, so you are inside the car, you are inside the train. If it would be a metro, it would be exactly the same. If it would be a tramway, tram, it would be exactly the same. You would use this en just because you are inside. Okay, so that's the reason why we make, well, the difference between en and then a. Okay, so you will use this a if you're talking bicycle or motorbike, or then by foot, of course. Okay, but then for this voiture, train, you will use this en. Okay, I hope it was clear. Other use is the languages. Okay, so for instance, il parle en espagnol. Parler is to talk, okay, or to speak. He speaks in Spanish, en espagnol. Or then, ce livre, this book, est en anglais. This book is in English, okay, en anglais. Other use is when you want to introduce the material, it is something is made of, okay, so for instance, une montre, montre is a watch, une montre, en or, okay, so gold, or, okay, so if you want to say that this watch is made of gold, then une montre en or. Un bateau en plastique. Bateau, it's a boat, and then plastique is plastic. So, un bateau en plastique. If you want to express the situation, you are in, okay, so for instance, to be late, être en retard. Être en retard, okay? And then the other option here, être en avance. All right, so if you're coming earlier, then être en avance. Être en vacances, to be on holiday, so être en vacances. So in all these situations, like en retard, en vacances, en avance, we will use this preposition en, okay? And then maybe the last use that I wanted to introduce is what we call the gérondif. So it's a bit tricky because we didn't yet see this participe présent. It will come soon, don't worry. But then I just wanted to be honest with you and introduce it, even if we didn't so yet. We didn't see yet the participe présent. So we will construct this gérondif. So the meaning of the gérondif is when you want to introduce so two actions. So we would say action simultanée. So technically, two actions that take place at the same time. Okay, and the way we construct that is, well, of course, because it's the lesson. So the preposition, la préposition en, and then after that you will put this participe présent form that you don't know yet how to make, but we'll see that in a coming lesson. Okay, but then I will make anyway an example. And this is the example. Je téléphone. Okay, so in the first sentence or in the first part of the sentence, you say je téléphone. Téléphone is to call. Okay, and then we have here our gérondif form. So first you've got your preposition en, and then you've got your participe présent form. So marchant. Okay, and if you look carefully, it's coming from the verb marcher. Marcher is to walk. Okay. Dans la rue. All right, so je téléphone en marchant dans la rue. So in that structure, you want to introduce the fact that you are making a phone call, you are calling someone, and at the same time, you are walking in the street. Okay, je téléphone en marchant dans la rue. All right, so that's the technique we've got to express two action that take place at the same time. It's this gérondif, okay? And then we construct this gérondif with the preposition en, okay? Les prépositions, so just to remind you, we've been seeing first in the previous lesson la préposition en, then before la préposition de, and even before la préposition à, and in this video, we'll see not the rest, of course, of all the prepositions, but the main prepositions that we will have in French language. Okay, so let's start now. And the first one that we'll see is pour, and pour means for. Okay, so we'll see two examples here. Ce café est pour vous. Okay, so ce café, this coffee, est, is pour, for, vous, you. Ce café est pour vous. Second example, je voudrais louer cette voiture pour 2 jours. Okay, so remember, here we've got this conditional form. So I would like to, louer means to rent, cette voiture, this car, pour 2 jours, for 2 days. Okay, je voudrais louer cette voiture pour 2 jours. Okay, second preposition or next one, sans, and it means without. Okay, so 2 examples. Elle voyage sans ses valises. Voyager is to travel, so she travels sans, without, ses valises, her luggages. Il vient sans son chien. Venir here is to come, so he comes sans, without, son chien, his dog. Okay. Après, you can translate it by after, okay? And then, je viens après la réunion. Venir is to come. Je viens, I come, après, after, la réunion, the meeting. Je viens après la réunion, okay? Then, avant means before. Il arrive avant toi. Arriver, to arrive, he arrives, avant, before, toi, you. Remember, this is what we call this pronom tonique. Okay, so it's you. Depuis means since or for. Okay, examples. Nous vivons ici depuis 2011. Okay, nous vivons, vivre is to live. Nous vivons, we live, ici, here, depuis, since. And then you put 2011, you just put the year. Okay? So, assuming the fact that we are still now in 2012, so 2012, we could use this sentence as well. Nous vivons ici depuis un an. Okay? So, in that case, you can use this depuis as well. And then you will introduce un an, just because we've been arriving in 2011, and we are now in 2012. Okay, so depuis un an. Derrière means behind. Okay, so the example could be le ballon est derrière l'arbre. Le ballon, the ball, est, is derrière, behind, l'arbre, the tree. Okay, un arbre, a tree. Le ballon est derrière l'arbre. Then after that, we can see devant. Devant means in front of. Okay, in front of. And then the example could be mon collègue, my colleague, est assis, is seated, devant le directeur. Le directeur, the director. Mon collègue est assis devant le directeur. Jusque means until. Example, je reste au bureau jusqu'à 17 heures. Okay, rester is to stay, au bureau, at the office. Je reste au bureau jusqu'à, until, 17 heures. Okay, so you can see that here it's quite interesting because normally we should have this jusque written like that. But then if you look carefully after that, we've got this a. Okay, another preposition. And then you remember the rule when we've got vowel and vowel. Normally what happens is that this final a will go away and then we'll put Sorry, we'll put apostrophe, so that's the reason why we get this jusqu'à, okay? And then phonetically, jusqu'à, okay? Je reste au bureau jusqu'à 17 heures. Sous means under. Simple example. Le livre est sous la table. Le livre, the book, est, is, sous, under, la table, the table. Le livre est sous la table. Sur means on. Okay, and then we've got two examples here. L'ordinateur est sur la table. So, l'ordinateur, the computer, est, is, sur, on, la table, the table. The computer is on the table, sur here. But then remember, or keep in mind that it's also possible to use this sur if we're talking about the wall, for instance. So, we could say l'affiche, so affiche is poster, l'affiche est sur le mur. All right, so it could be for la table or any other things like that, and then as well for le mur, okay, sur le mur. Avec, so the classic one, means with. Elle parle avec son frère. Parler is to talk. Son frère, her brother. Elle parle, she talks, avec, with, her brother, son frère. Elle parle avec son frère. She, so this one is quite interesting because if you really want to translate it, so you're talking about a place, okay, but then you're talking about someone's place. So it's the place connected to a person. So let's see a few examples now. Je suis chez moi. So if you want to say that you are at your place, then you should use this chez, okay, and then here in that case, you will put this moi, so pronom tonique. Je suis chez moi. Okay, so this is the first use that you could have. Okay, if you want to introduce this chez and then use the name of someone, it's possible, like here. Nous sommes invités chez Laurent. Okay, so we are invited at Laurent's place, if you want to translate it directly, okay? So that's the way we will use, if we've got a name and we want to introduce the fact that it's at the place of this person, then it's chez, okay? And so it will work the same way if we want to talk about, for instance, here, the doctor, or then we can say le boulanger, le boucher. Normally we tend to use this chez if we're talking about whether little shops or offices, and traditionally or before, the person used to live whether above or then behind or in this place, okay? So that's the reason why we tend to use this chez, okay? Because it is connected to the person more than to the shop itself. So, il va chez le médecin. Il va chez le médecin. Contre means against. One example. Nous sommes contre cette décision. Okay, this decision, and it's nous sommes, we are against this decision. Nous sommes contre cette décision. Dans, so you can, it means in, inside or into. Okay, so let's see now. Alexandre est dans la voiture. Okay, Alexandre is dans, inside, in la voiture, the car. Okay, nous entrons dans le magasin. Entrer, to enter, to go inside. Okay, dans le magasin, the shop. Okay, par will mean by or per. For example, une lettre envoyée par la poste. Okay, une lettre, a letter, envoyée, sent, par la poste, by mail. Okay, so in that case, you get to use this par. Okay, it could be par courrier électronique, by email if you want. Okay, je mange 5 fruits et légumes par jour. Okay, so in that case, it would be this per day. Okay, par jour. Je mange, I eat, 5, 5 fruits, fruits et légumes. Légumes is vegetables. Par jour. Okay, per day. Je mange 5 fruits et légumes par jour. Pendant means during. Il dort pendant le film. OK? Dormir is to sleep. Pendant, during, le film, the movie. Il dort pendant le film. Vers, so you don't pronounce the final S, means towards or about. Je vais vers la station de métro. OK? So I am walking in that case because I used to say je vais, so I'm sorry, it's aller, okay? Je vais vers la station de métro, so I go, so you can walk or maybe you could drive, in fact, but then je vais, I go towards, donc la station de métro, okay? Or then it would be possible to use it as well if you get this sentence, nous avons rendez-vous vers 15 heures, okay? Nous avons rendez-vous. So avoir rendez-vous, it's when you have a meeting, okay? So avoir, to have, and then rendez-vous. Remember that in French, it's not so romantic at all. You know, you can have a rendez-vous at your dentist, for instance. So it's like we have meeting vers, around, about, okay? 15 heures, okay? So you just want to say that it's not, you know, 15 heures précises, okay? But it's about or around. Voici could be translated with this is, okay? So, and we tend to use it quite often if we introduce persons. So, voici mon ami Frédéric. And then normally, you know, it goes with voilà, okay? And then voilà will mean there is, okay? So, I did make this little example, so I took back this. Voici mon ami Frédéric et voilà mon ami Arnaud. Okay, so voilà normally will come after voici. Bonjour à tous, hi everyone and welcome to Learn French with Vincent and this is Unité 9, leçon N. And in this lesson, we'll see together les temps composés. So we won't discover them because I thought it might be useful to take the time to review what we saw so far, especially when we're talking about les temps composés, so all these tenses that are composed tenses, okay? So, and so far, we've been seeing first le passé composé, then we saw le plus que parfait, after that came le futur antérieur, and finally, we saw le conditionnel passé. And so, the common thing that we have between all these tenses is that they are composed, okay? So they will be constructed the same way, but then of course a few things will change. Obviously, the first part that we've got to use, avoir and être, will change, but then the rest, construction with the participe passé, will be the same, okay? So we'll first start with the passé composé, okay? So, and if you remember, the rule was that first we will use avoir. So if you're not really sure, if you don't remember if the verb requires être or not, then put avoir. Avoir should be at the present form. Then you will put your participe passé form and you will get this passé composé. Okay? Remember that in some cases, but we're talking about exceptions or reflexive verbs, you know, these se, blah, blah, blah. So you will have to use être and at the present tense as well, plus le participe passé, and you will get this passé composé. Okay? So, of course, it looks simple like that, but then in some cases, and especially after learning so many things, maybe you don't really remember the conjugation of avoir and être at the present tense. So we'll take the time to review that one more time. So remember, avoir at the present tense goes like j'ai, tu as, il a, elle a, nous avons, vous avez, ils ont, elles ont. Okay, so j'ai, tu as, final S not pronounced, il a, elle a, nous avons, final S not pronounced, and then we make this little link between the two. Nous avons, vous avez, a Z at the end will produce this E sound, avez, little link between the two, vous avez, ils ont, okay, final T not pronounced, and then we make the liaison, ils ont, elles ont. All right, so this is for avoir at the present tense. And now être at the present tense. Je suis, tu es, il est, elle est, nous sommes, vous êtes, ils sont, elles sont. Okay, so je suis, final S not pronounced. Tu es, okay, so it's quite strange because you get this ES, but then phonetically it's est, all right, quite open. Tu es. Il est exactly the same sound as we had previously. Okay, so just remember that you write it like that, but then phonetically it goes like est, elle est. Nous sommes, final S not pronounced. Vous êtes, little liaison to be between the two and then final S not pronounced. Ils sont, final T not pronounced. Elles sont. All right, so that's the main thing you should remember. Of course, the participe passé, but then we won't cover that in this lesson because I've been making a big video on that. So try to search it in the channel search engine, and you will find it. Okay. So let's see now. Le plus que parfait. So remember, it was exactly the same rule. So first, avoir. If you're not sure, just put avoir. But avoir should be at the imparfait form. Then the participe passé, so you will get your plus que parfait, okay? And for the same exceptions, we'll have être at the imparfait form, and then the participe passé, and it will give you the plus que parfait. Okay, so for the same reasons, we will see together avoir at the imparfait and être at the imparfait, just to make sure that it's clear for you. And avoir at the imparfait will give j'avais. Tu avais, il avait, elle avait, nous avions, vous aviez, ils avaient, elles avaient. Okay, so j'avais, final S not pronounced, tu avais, final S not pronounced, il avait, final T not pronounced, elle avait. So exactly the same phonetical thing here, it's avait. Nous avions, final S not pronounced, and then little liaison, nous avions. Vous aviez, a Z at the end, et, aviez, and then liaison, vous aviez. Ils avaient, so look here, ENT, you write them, you don't pronounce them. So you get phonetically avait, exactly the same thing that we had here, here, and here. Okay, so it's exactly the same thing that you will pronounce. But then here you make the liaison. Ils avaient, elles avaient. Okay, let's see how être goes. J'étais, tu étais, il était, elle était, nous étions, vous étiez, ils étaient, elles étaient. All right, so exactly the same rule. Remember, final S here, here, final T, and then here, ENT, you don't pronounce them. So you will get était, okay, for all these forms, okay? J'étais, tu étais, il était, elle était. Same rule here, final S not pronounced, and then you make the liaison. Nous étions, vous étiez, ils étaient, elles étaient. Okay? Make the liaison here as well. Ils étaient, elles étaient. All right? So, this is the thing you should remember. Now, the other tense we saw was futur antérieur. And futur antérieur, remember, exactly the same construction, but then avoir should be conjugated at the future, le futur, and then le participe passé, and it will give you futur antérieur. Or then, for exactly the same exceptions and the same cases, you will use être, but then être should be at the future tense. Plus le participe passé, and it will give you le futur antérieur. So, what we'll see, We'll see exactly the same thing as we saw previously for the other tenses, so or the other tenses. So we'll see the future form for avoir and then the future form for être. Okay? And for avoir, it will go like j'aurai, tu auras, il aura, elle aura, nous aurons, vous aurez, ils auront, elles auront. Okay, so have a look now. J'aurai, tu auras, final S not pronounced, il aura, elle aura, nous aurons, final S not pronounced, and then you make the liaison, vous aurez, a Z at the end here, et aurez, liaison here, vous aurez, ils auront, final T not pronounced, elles auront. Okay, and then for être, we will get je serai, tu seras, il sera, elle sera, nous serons, vous serez, ils seront, elles seront. Okay, so one more time. Je serai, tu seras, final S not pronounced, il sera, elle sera, nous serons, final S not pronounced, vous serez, a Z at the end, et serez, ils seront, final T not pronounced, elles seront. All right, so this is the future tense for avoir and être, okay? And now the last composed tense we saw was le conditionnel passé, and so remember that le conditionnel passé will go like that. So first, as we saw previously, avoir in priority at the conditionnel présent form, then you put your participe passé, and you will get your conditionnel passé. Or for the same cases as we had previously for passé composé, futur antérieur, or then plus que parfait, être, but in that case it should be at the conditionnel present form, then the participe passé, and you will get your conditionnel passé form. So let's see now how avoir and être are at the conditionnel present, just to refresh your memory, and it goes like that. J'aurais, tu aurais, il aurait, elle aurait, nous aurions, vous auriez, ils auraient, elles auraient. Okay, so one more time. J'aurais, final S not pronounced, tu aurais, same thing here, il aurait, elle aurait, final T not pronounced, so phonetically exactly the same form here. Nous aurions, final S not pronounced, and then you get this liaison, nous aurions. Vous auriez, a Z at the end, et auriez, and then the liaison, vous auriez. Ils auraient, remember, E-N-T, you don't pronounce it, auraient, ils auraient, elles auraient. Alright, so this is for avoir, and then let's see, être. Je serai, tu serais, il serait, elle serait, nous serions, vous seriez, il serait, elle serait. Okay, so let's see how it goes. Je serai, final S not pronounced. Tu serais, same thing here. Il serait, elle serait, final T not pronounced. Nous serions, final S not pronounced. Vous seriez, a Z at the end, et seriez. Il serait, so a N T not pronounced, elle serait. All right, so this is the first part that you should use when you make this conditionnel passé form, okay? That's it for les temps composés. If you've got some doubts, remember I've been making videos regarding each of these tenses, so it's possible to find them. If you want more video or other videos, then remember youtube.com/imagier is here, and then more material if you want to find other things, softwares or pictures or flashcards. Imagier.net is waiting for you. Have a great day. Bye bye. L'impératif. Okay, so as usual, when we see a tense, we first work on l'emploi, so when do we use it, and then after that we'll see la formation, so how do we construct this impératif form. Okay, but then first, of course, l'emploi. So when do we use the impératif? Well, it's quite simple. We've got three main uses of l'impératif. The first one, le conseil. So if you want to translate conseil, it would be advice, okay? So if you want to give an advice to someone, okay, in most of the cases you will use this imperative form. Or then if you want to give an order, Okay, so normally that's the tense we use if we want to use this order thing. And then la défense, so if you want to forbid something to someone, okay, so in that case you should use l'impératif. Okay, so conseil, ordre, ou défense. Okay, we'll see just a few examples just to see how it works. Le conseil, so we've got this example. Pour aller à la gare, tourner à gauche et continuer tout droit. Okay, so to go to the station, aller is to go, la gare, the station. Pour aller à la gare, tourner, and that's our first impératif, à gauche, on your left, et continuer, continue is to continue, tout droit, straight. Okay, so tourner and continuer here are at the imperative form. Okay, normally at this level, maybe it rings a bell, and maybe you can think that they look like something we saw previously. Okay, so ordre now, if you want to give an order, same thing here. Fais tes devoirs. Okay, so faire is to give, sorry, to do, sorry. And then tes devoirs, your homework. Okay, we tend to put that at the plural form in French. Fais tes devoirs. Okay, and this is here as well an impératif. Okay, and then let's see now. Une défense. N'utilisez pas votre téléphone portable pendant le cours. So, of course, in that case, défense, you want to forbid something, so you should use this negative form. Okay, so n'utilisez pas votre téléphone portable pendant, during le cours, the lesson. Okay, utiliser is to use. N'utilisez pas votre téléphone portable pendant le cours. Same thing here. Utiliser is at the imperative form. Okay. So now, first thing. When we talk about this imperative form, the first thing that you've got to remember is that we've got only three persons. So there will be tu, nous, and then vous. So the imperative doesn't exist for je. For il and il au pluriel. Okay? And then the second thing that you should remember is that you won't use these pronoms personnels. So normally, when we've got a tense, well, so far, all the tenses that we saw, you use these pronoms personnels. So tu, nous, and vous. Okay? The concept with the imperative is that you won't use tu, either nous or vous. Okay? So you don't use this pronom personnel. All right, so these two things are the main thing. First, only three persons, tu, nous, and vous. And the second thing, you don't use the pronom personnel. Okay, let's see now how we build this imperative form. So we'll see first the premier groupe, then we'll see the deuxième groupe, and then the troisième groupe, and finally, of course, as usual, the irregular verbs. All right, so let's start with the first group, le premier groupe. So normally the first group, and it's been that way so far, is the easy group because it is regular. In that case, for the imperative, well, it will be the tricky group, okay? Because for instance, at the present form, we've got tu parles. Okay, so that's the present form of the verb parler, parler to talk, from the from the first group. Okay, if we want to make this imperative form, well, it will look like that, parle. So you can see that your final s needs to go away, and you will get this parle form. This is your imperative form, so l'impératif, and then don't forget to put le point d'exclamation here, because whether it's an order or an advice, you should put it. Okay, that's the way it goes. And then remember, we don't put the pronom personnel. So just this form. Okay, so that's the first form of parler at the impératif. Then nous parlons. So this is the present form. Okay, well, it's quite easy. You don't touch it, you don't change anything, you just put it back here. Don't put the pronom personnel, of course, just put this point d'exclamation at the end, and you've got your imperative form, so parlons. Okay? And then vous parlez, well, same thing here, you just keep it like it is at the present form, and you just put your point d'exclamation at the end. So what you need to remember is that the only thing that will change, so between the present form here and this imperative form, is this final S that normally we don't pronounce, but still we write it. Okay, so it needs to go away at the imperative for the tu form. Okay, let's see now verbs from the second group. So I took this finir to end, to finish. Okay, so tu finis at the present form, and have a look, it's exactly the same form, fini. Okay, point d'exclamation, and you take away the pronom personnel. All right, then nous finissons, exactly the same form, finissons. Don't forget the point d'exclamation at the end, and you take away this nous. Vous finissez, and you will get finissez. Okay, so what you've got to remember, second group of verbs, actually they will be exactly the same as at the present form. Okay, so no change. Of course you need to take away the pronom personnel, but the forms will stay the same. Okay, so let's see now the troisième group. So normally in most of the cases, troisième group is the contain all the tricky verbs. Okay, but then if you take the example of prendre, prendre is to take, tu prends at the present form. Okay, well, look, it is exactly the same thing. Keep in mind that, of course, you should put this point d'interrogation at the end, point d'exclamation at the end, and then you take away this pronom personnel, but still, it's the same form, all right? Then, nous prenons at the present form, we'll get this prenons. And the last one, vous prenez, you will get prenez, okay? So, third group of verbs, actually it's quite easy because you don't touch anything, you don't change anything, you just take away this pronom personnel and you will have your imperative form. Okay, of course, as usual in French, we've got some irregular verbs. Okay, so the first one will be aller. Okay, so aller will be like that. So the only thing that will change with aller is, well, what we saw in the first group, the final S will go away. So you get va, allons, allez. Okay, the other forms are exactly the same. Savoir will become sache, sachons, sachez. Ouvrir, ouvre, so the S goes away, ouvrons, ouvrez. Okay, aller is to go, savoir to know, ouvrir to open. Okay, then of course être and avoir. So être will become soit. Remember, final S is not pronounced. Soit. Then soyons, soyez. All right, soit, soyons, soyez. And avoir will become est. Remember, the final is not pronounced, so you only have this A-E sound, E, okay? E, ayons, ayez, okay? E, ayons, ayez, okay? So one more time, soit, soyons, soyez, then E, ayons, ayez, all right? And now, remember that all these tricky verbs will be modified if you put a pronoun after. Okay, and we're talking about only two categories of pronouns. So we saw the pronouns previously, so you should know now what pronouns I'm talking about. So I'm talking about this pronoun I here, so the Y pronoun, and I'm talking about the pronoun en, okay? So, because in most of the, well, not most of the cases, but quite often in French, when we use the imperative, we tend to avoid repeating things, so we will put pronouns if needed and if possible, okay? So, in that case, for instance, remember, pense, so it's from the first group, so normally when you put this imperative, you shouldn't put the S, okay? But then if you put this Y, so this pronoun after, then you will have to put back this S, just to produce it orally, because you will pronounce it pense-y, pense-y, okay? Pense-y, all right? So you get to make this liaison. Same thing here, vas-y, vas-y, all right? And then achète-en, achète-en, all right? So that's one important thing if you want to construct this imperative form with pronouns. Then now we'll see how to construct this imperative when we've got the negative form. After that, we'll see how it works if you've got only one pronoun and pronom complément, and then one or two in that case. And then finally, we'll see with the verb pronominaux. But then now first, la négation. So I took this parler verb, and if you have a look at it, so imperative is parle, okay? If you want to write the same sentence but at the negative form, well, it's quite easy because it will be ne parle pas, okay? So you just put your ne before the verb and then the pas after the verb, and of course you don't change the rest. Finir, finissons, ne finissons pas, okay? So same concept, ne first, then your verb, and after that, and then mettre, mettez, will become ne mettez pas. Okay, so it's not that difficult. Now let's see with the pronouns, okay? And then first part will be with one pronoun, and after that we'll see how to construct that with two pronouns, and it is a bit difficult if I'm totally honest with you. But now with one pronoun, let's see, regarde-moi. Okay, and it will become at the negative form ne me regarde pas. Okay, so here normally remember these pronouns me, okay, should come before the verb. Then the rule at the imperative is that if you've got this structure, so structure affirmative, okay, so it's not the negative form, then they should come after, and then this me is one of the pronouns that will change and it will become moi. Regarde-moi, okay? But when you put back this structure to the negative form, so me just become the normal form, so ne me regarde pas, all right? Same thing, so toi will be the second and the last to be drastically modified, so it will become regarde-toi, okay? So the rules stay the same, you put it after, okay? Regarde-toi. All right, but then when you put the negative form, well, it becomes normal, so ne and then te regarde pas. Okay, keep in mind that as usual for the pronouns, they will come before the verb, okay? So your negative form is coming before and after the whole thing. And then, well, if you've got this le pronoun, or it could be the la, well, it will stay the same, so no modification, so regarde-le, and then negative form, ne le regarde pas, okay? Regarde-la, ne la regarde pas. It could be regarde-nous, okay? Ne, whoops, sorry, I made a mistake, it should be nous here, ne nous regarde pas, okay? And the last one, regarde-les will become ne les regarde pas. Okay, so keep in mind that it's only this me and te pronouns that will change. They will become this moi and toi. So they will become these forms, and you should put each time anyway after the verb. And don't forget this little thing between the two, because as you can see, we've got to put it. Okay, now if you want to put two pronouns in your structure with the imperative, well, it's something that's, well, it's not really rare to use that, okay? But then, well, we've got some, of course, as usual, quite strict rules, and that's the thing. The first part that you will have will be me or m apostrophe, te or t apostrophe, lui, then nous, and leur, okay? So that will be the first thing that you will have to put, and after that will come your pronoun en, okay? That's normally the association of pronouns that we've got. Okay, so let's see them in action. For instance, parlement. Okay, so as you see, first you put this M apostrophe and then you put your pronoun. Okay, don't forget that they must come after your verb because it's the imperative. Parlement. Okay, but if you put them at the negative form, then you will get ne m'en parle pas. Okay, remember, negative form, then they come back as they should be all the time, so before the verb. All right, so another example, parle-nous en. Okay, here, and then we will get ne nous en parle pas. Okay, sorry for the examples, but I tend to not to make the liaison when I make these little examples, just because I think it's more clear not to make the liaison. Okay, but then of course, parle-nous-en, ne nous en parle pas should be the way you should pronounce them. Okay, but still, just to make it clear where you put them and to avoid any mistake or anything like that. Okay, so same thing here. So parle, and then after that you've got a pronoun and second pronoun en. But when you put the negative form, ne, and then you put them back before your verb. Okay? Second possibility that you would have would be the pronouns like le, la, and les. Okay? And they will come first, and after that you will have this moi, lui, nous, and leur. Okay? Let's see a few examples now. Donne-la-moi. Okay, donne-la-moi. So exactly the same rule as we saw previously. Okay, so you put them after your verb, like that. Okay, but of course, when you put the negative form, then you put them back. Look, ne me la donne pas. Donne-la-moi, ne me la donne pas. Then, donne-la-nous. And it will become, ne nous la donne pas. Alright, so I know this is really difficult, so don't worry, because many students have some difficulties at the beginning, okay? But then little by little, you will understand the structure and the way to construct that, okay? Just try to keep that in mind, okay? Try to listen to persons and then try to use this structure. But remember that in many cases it's possible to avoid repeating or to avoid, sorry, using the pronouns by repeating a few words, okay? So it's, well, it's an option as well, okay? So let's see now les verbes pronominaux, okay? And so I took this se regarder verb, okay? So regarde-toi. And then if you put the same structure, but then at the negative form, so ne te regarde pas. Regardons-nous, ne nous regardons pas, regardez-vous, ne vous regardez pas. Okay, so exactly the same thing as we saw previously. So, toi, nous, and vous should come after the verb. Okay, but when you put this structure at the negative form, so te, nous, and vous should come before the verb. Okay, so that's the rule. Les liaisons obligatoire. So since we started this Learn French with Vincent videos, I've been talking quite much about les liaisons, so these little links that you can put between the words. And so of course we've got some rules for these things, and so I thought that maybe it might be useful to just cover this topic right now, because I've been receiving few messages regarding this topic. So this video will only focus on les liaisons obligatoires, so the one you should make, okay, and after that we'll see well, the one that you shouldn't make, and then the one that are optional, so it's possible to make them or not. Okay, but in this video, we'll focus only on the one that you should make. So let's start now. So the first situation when you should make it, it's when you use these articles définis. So le, la, les, remember, the in English. And then when you've got the plural form, so it's les It's like that, and then it ends with this S. If you've got a word after, and then it's starting with a vowel like this one, amis, friends, then you should make the liaison. Les amis. All right? Les amis. Then second possibility here, les articles indéfinis. So in English, a, but then in French, we've got the difference between the masculine, un, une, des, okay? And then I took the plural form just to make it clearer. So des here, ending with S, and then you've got a word after, étudiants, students. So it starts with a vowel, so you should make the connection, the liaison between the two, des étudiants. All right? Other possibility, when you get these, well, the adjective possessive, so when you say my, your, etc. So in French, it would go like that. So in that case, my children, so it should be at the plural because this children is at the plural, okay? So it goes like that, and then ending with S, enfants, children is starting with a vowel, so you should make the liaison, mes enfants, all right? And of course, les adjectifs démonstratifs, sorry, this or these, okay? And in that case, I took the plural form, so these here, and then ordinateur, computers. So you should make the liaison between S and O, ces ordinateurs, ces ordinateurs. Okay, so les amis, des étudiants, mes enfants, ces ordinateurs. So in these cases, you should make the liaison without any doubt, okay? And so we also have this interrogative situation. So when you ask a question, remember, we use this quel, okay? It's what, but then of course, as usual in French, we've got the difference between the masculine, the feminine, and the plural, feminine plural. In that case, I did use this option, it's feminine and it's plural, so that's the reason why I write this quel like that. And it ends with S. Option is starting with a vowel. You should make the liaison between the two. Quelles options? Quelles options? All right? And then if you, well, heard from the beginning, you know, the concept of this liaison is that you don't make any pause between the two words. Quelles options? It's really a link between the two. Quelles options? Indéfini, well, exactly the same rule. In that case, you've got certains, indéfini, and it is here at the plural form, individu, plural, starting with a vowel, you make the liaison, certains individus, all right? And the last situation for this page, numéro, okay? So if we're talking about the numbers, in that case, I took trois, okay, three, just because it ends with S, as you can see here, and then appartement, apartments, starting with a vowel, so you should make the liaison. Trois appartements. Okay? So, quelles options? Certains individus. Trois appartements. So, in all these cases, you should make the liaison. All right? But then it continues. So, now, situation where you've got a sentence in which you've got first the adjective and then the noun. Like here, for instance. Les beaux enfants. Okay? So, you make the liaison between beau, so adjective, and enfant. And here it's quite interesting because even if you've got this X, well, phonetically it will be like Z, so like if it would be an S, okay? Les beaux enfants, all right? Les jeunes étudiants, all right? So same thing here, the link between the two, les jeunes étudiants, all right? And then if you've got this pronom personnel, so I, you, he, she, etc., and then your verb, so in that case, I took vous, okay, and then the verb to être, the verb être, to be, so in that case you get vous êtes, so you make the liaison between the two, and then avoir, to have, nous avons, alright, so remember, pronom personnel, then the verb, you make the liaison. And then it's quite interesting because this verb être, so to be, if it's at the third person of the singular, so he is or she is, il est, elle est, okay, then definitely you should make the liaison if you've got something after. So like here, for instance, il est admirable, ta, il est admirable, okay, elle est intéressée, all right, so in all these cases you should make the liaison, and in that case it's with T. Il est admirable, elle est intéressée. And it continues. If you've got this structure in which you've got the pronom complément before the verb, okay, so we've been doing few videos regarding this topic. If you don't know how to make them well, you can check them. There are many videos regarding this topic. And so remember the pronoun should be before the verb. So when you've got this kind of structure, subject, pronoun, verb, in that case you should make the liaison between the two. Il nous aide. Il nous aide. Elle vous admire. Elle vous admire. All right, so z, z here as well. Elle vous admire. Il nous aide. Okay? If you've got the verb first and then you put your pronoun after, because normally that's the way we should proceed, you know, if we want to construct a correct question. Normally you should put the first the verb and after the pronoun. Okay? So in this situation, then you should make the liaison. And so this little D here is in red just to show you that you won't pronounce it like D to make the liaison, but you will pronounce it like T. And so you will get prend-il, prend-il, okay? But then here, prennent-elle, okay? So you've got your T and then prennent-elle, all right? So prend-il, remember, D pronounced like T, and here, prennent-elle. All right, and so if you want to construct a structure in which you will have whether une conjonction, so these little words that will link whether words or then sentences, or then if it's une préposition, many videos regarding that topic as well, or adverb, but then they should be only one syllable long, okay? So like that, quand elle. All right, same rule here. Remember, when you will have this D, you will phonetically pronounce it like T. Quand elle, dans un. Okay, and in that case, you've got this préposition dans, okay, and then the article, dans un. All right, and here we've got this adverb, beaucoup, and then admirer, beaucoup, beaucoup admirer. Sorry, beaucoup admirer. All right, quand elle, dans un, beaucoup admirer. All right, so let's repeat them. Il nous aide, elle vous admire, prend-il, prennent-elles, quand-elles, dans un, beaucoup admirer. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 9, Leçon Q. And in this lesson, we'll see together les liaisons interdites. So remember, les liaisons. It's actually this little link that we can put between the words when we read or when we speak. Okay, so in the previous lesson, we saw les liaisons, so the one that you have to do. Okay, so the rules that you've got to follow if you really want to make this liaison properly. And then in this video, well, we'll try to see the one that you shouldn't do. Okay, because in some cases, it's not possible to make these liaison. Okay, so let's see now. And the first one is actually the maybe the most important one, because normally students tend to make this mistake quite often at the beginning, which is totally normal, because if you think about that, we've got this et conjonction, so it means and in English, okay? And so normally students tend to think that when you've got, you know, lui et elle like that, well, why not put this little liaison between the two? Because it would be quite logical. After all, we tend to make it and to put it, you know, a little bit everywhere. But in that case, sorry about that. The rule is really strict. So after this conjonction et, like we've got here, you don't make any liaison. So no links after et. Okay, so if you want to read it correctly here, it will go like lui et elle. All right, so don't think about putting something between the two. Don't think about producing something like lui est-elle. No, nothing here. Lui et elle. Okay, and it will be exactly the same thing in this example here. Toi et eux. All right, so no liaison, even if it's a bit tempting because it would be possible, but then no, No. So when you get this A, remember no liaison after. Okay? Then after that, we've got this structure or this possibility in which you've got a question like here and here, okay? And you start your question with an adverb, okay? And that's, of course, what we call adverb interrogatif because it's a question. So, comment, how, as-tu, okay? So, do you have, okay? Or have you? But in that case, remember that if you start with an adverb like here, so avec an adverb, don't make the liaison. So you don't say comment as-tu? No, no, no. Nothing here. Comment as-tu? All right? Exactly the same thing here. Quand, when, and then ont-ils? Here you've got this little thing. Quand ont-ils? Quand ont-ils? All right? So you don't make a liaison here between the two. Okay? It was the second rule. And then remember that if you've got a noun and if this noun is at the singular form, then you shouldn't make the liaison. Like here, for instance, un chien, a dog, adorable. Okay, here it would be tempting to do it, but then no liaison. So un chien adorable. Okay, same thing here, une maison étrange. Okay, house. And then étrange, strange. Une maison étrange, un chien adorable. Okay, remember, you shouldn't make any liaison here after this word and after this word. And then, if you've got this participe passé form, so it does mean that whether it is at the, like here or here, it is at the passé composé form, all right? So, ils sont sortis, okay, so if we take the time to have a look at it, here you've got first être, and here you've got the participe passé form, and the whole thing gives you this passé composé, okay, exactly the same thing here, so we've got the verb être to be, and after that, here we've got this participe passé form, and this form together give you the passé composé form, okay, so in that case, if you think about what we said, so après le participe passé, so if we spot it, this is the participe passé, sorti, and this is here, the participe passé, and well, both end with S, it would be possible to make a link, you know, between S and A here, and S and AU here, but then the rule is quite strict, you don't make a liaison after your participe passé, okay, so ils sont sortis à 15h. All right, so no liaison here, no link between the two. Ils sont sortis à 15h. Exactly the same thing here. Elles sont allées au cinéma. All right, elles sont allées au cinéma. So, no liaison after your participe passé here. Okay? And then, well, a quite important thing as well, après un verbe conjugué avec tu. Many persons sent me messages regarding this thing when I do the conjugation and when I conjugate the verbs. They say that, you know, it's quite strange because you don't make the liaison when it's for tu. Well, just because it's a rule. You shouldn't make the liaison when you conjugate a verb at the tu form, okay? Don't ask me why, because basically there's no logic in that, you know? It's just the way it is, so that's one rule, and honestly, it's a bit strange. I know, especially when you're learning language, for what reason, only for one person, you shouldn't make the liaison, but unfortunately for you, that's the way we do it, so let's respect the rule. So in that case, if you look at the sentence, so you've got first your subject, so tu, and then here you've got est, okay, and so this is the verb être, and the second form, second person of the singular, so tu es admirable, all right? And in that case, well, don't make the liaison, okay? Tu es admirable. And it will be exactly the same thing here. Tu parles avec nous. So, no liaison here between parle and avec. Okay? Tu parles avec nous. All right, so that's the rule. When you've got a verb at the tu person, okay, so second person of the singular, don't make a liaison after the verb. All right? And then when you've got this interesting structure, so if we've got the pronoun, so the subject, and it's after your verb, like here, because normally that's the way, I mean, that's the official way that we should, we should respect. If we want to ask a question, first we should put the verb, then we should put the subject, okay? So, veulent-ils, all right? So it should go like that. And then, if you've got, something after, like here, allez avec nous, okay? It could be possible if you think about that. We've got an S here and then we've got a vowel after. But then the rule goes like that. If you've got this structure, so in which your pronoun is coming after your verb because it's a question, then you don't make the liaison, okay? Veulent-ils aller avec nous? Okay, exactly the same thing here. Parle-t-il en anglais? Okay, so no liaison after your pronoun. Okay, just because the structure is like that. First you've been having your verb, then your pronoun, then you don't make a liaison. And another rule is if you've got like here, ses ordinateurs, or like here, mes étudiants. Okay, so in these two sentences, ses ordinateurs, it's the subject, okay, mes étudiants, subject, and then you've got the verb coming after, all right? And so the concept or the idea is that if you've got a subject like that, but then it's what we call un groupe nominal, okay? So in that case, it's not a first name, or then it's not a pronoun, je, tu, il, etc. But it's, you know, a word or a group of words. And in that case, you don't make a liaison after this groupe nominal. So in that case, ses ordinateurs, you don't make the liaison between this word and the verb that will come after. Okay? Ces ordinateurs ont, and the sentence continues. Okay? Same thing here. Mes étudiants apprennent. And the sentence continues. So the concept is quite strict. Remember, you've got your subject, so it must be something like that. Okay? So you've got group of words, okay, and after that you won't make the liaison with the verb, okay? And then this is quite interesting because it's what we call un H aspiré, okay? So for instance, in this case, well, I did put that in a big letter because it's a place in Paris, okay? So, but in that case still, even if you've got this H, okay, it belongs to this aspiré group of words, so containing this H, okay, and it means that you won't have the possibility to make the liaison between your article and your word. So in that case, you shouldn't make the liaison, so you shouldn't say les Halles, but you should say les Halles. Okay, les Halles. Same thing here, H, it's an X, okay, and in that case it's the plural form. Les H, okay, les H. Okay, so you don't say les H, but you say les H. All right, so I did write two other examples. In that case, harpe, so the musical instrument. Des harpes, okay, so you don't make the liaison between the two. Des harpes, and the last one, hiérarchie. Des hiérarchies, okay, so just to show you that it's not only with A, because I've got three examples with A, but then in that case it's I, okay, des hiérarchies. All right, so no liaison here, 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 and here. All right, because these words are starting with what we call H aspirer. And that's it. Okay, so if you want more videos, youtube.com/imagier, or the website is waiting for you, imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Liaison optionnelle. So it does mean that it's possible to make them. It's not compulsory, but still it would be advisable to make them. So I know for what reason should I do only one video for that. Well, it's just to give you the opportunity to choose whether you want to make them or not, because in both cases it would be possible. Okay, so let's start now. Les liaisons optionnelles. And the first one will be après le verbe aller. Okay, so remember that it will be possible first to say je vais avoir un chien, so you don't make the liaison. Or if you want to make it, it is possible, je vais avoir un chien. Okay, first option possible, je vais avoir un chien. Then if you want to make the liaison, it's also possible, je vais avoir un chien. Ils vont habiter en France without the liaison, or ils vont habiter en France with the liaison. Okay, ils vont habiter en France. All right. Second possibility, après le verbe être. Exactly the same thing. It's possible to read this sentence like je suis intéressé par l'histoire. Or then, you can read it with the liaison. Je suis intéressé par l'histoire. Second example here. Ils sont arrivés ce soir. Or then, ils sont arrivés ce soir. Après le verbe avoir, well, it's exactly the same rule. Nous avons une amie. Or then, nous avons une amie. Ils ont un chien. Or if you want to make the liaison, ils ont un chien. Same thing with the verb falloir. Il faut admettre ses erreurs. Or then, if you want to make the liaison, il faut admettre ses erreurs. Il faut étudier beaucoup. Or, with the liaison, il faut étudier beaucoup. The verb devoir will follow exactly the same rule. First option, je dois être chez lui dans 15 minutes. Or then, je dois être chez lui dans 15 minutes. Ils doivent attendre mon arrivée. Or if you want to make the liaison, ils doivent attendre mon arrivée. Same thing with the verb pouvoir. Elle peut arriver demain. Or then if you want to make the liaison, elle peut arriver demain. Nous pouvons inviter cette personne. Or if you want to make the liaison, nous pouvons inviter cette personne. It will be exactly the same thing with the verb vouloir. Je veux entendre sa musique. Or then with the liaison, je veux entendre sa musique. Okay, remember, we had the same rule. Even if we've got this X at the end, well, with the liaison, it will sound like Z. Okay? Je veux entendre. Je veux entendre. Je veux entendre sa musique. Okay? Then, elles veulent attendre avec moi. Or if you want to put the liaison, elles veulent attendre avec moi. And then, other option, entre un nom pluriel et l'adjectif. Okay, so here we've got a group of words. If you look carefully, first you've got a noun, then you've got an adjective. Well, both are at the plural form. Okay, and so the rule is like entre un nom pluriel et l'adjectif. So we're talking about here and here. Okay, but it's optional. It's not compulsory. You don't need to do it if you don't want to do it, but it's possible. Okay, so first option, des personnes étrangères. Or if you want to make the liaison, des personnes étrangères. des amis irlandais, or if you want to make the liaison, des amis irlandais. And then I made two more here. Des étudiants intelligents, or if you want to make the liaison, des étudiants intelligents. Des lampes artificielles, and if you want to make the liaison, des lampes artificielles.